First Community Bank, Community Hospital, Home Health and Hospice, Louise Chicken Fingers, Neptune Technology Group, CB&S Bank, HDB Broadband, Parker Tire Service Center, Tallassee Superfoods, Grove Station, Bath Innovations of Alabama, Grove's Barbecue,
1-2-3 testing, 1-2-3.
Tallassee Power and Equipment, First Methodist Church,
testing, 1-2, 1-2, testing, 1-2. All right.
Tallassee Rehab. Tallassee True Value.
Testing. Testing.
1-2-3.
State Farm Insurance Agent Albert Elmore.
Test one. Test one.
State Farm Insurance
Test one.
Agent
Test one. 1-2, 1-2, 1-2.
Attorney Mike Siegel. Right. Parties of Tallassee. City Collision. Urban Tales. Godwin's Flowers. New Stone Realty. Hornsby and Son Body Shop. Maypop's Barbecue. Simply Southern Acre Storage and Power Sports. Southeastern Insurance.
Southeastern.
Tiger Paw, Bullseye Pest Control, Sunbelt Lawn Works, Seppo K Tree Service,
Marbury. I thought I'd switch that.
And TallasseeTimes.com.
Why does it do this? I had updated that. It's still saying Marbury.
What, over here on the computer?
Yeah.
Tallassee. You sure you got the live feed? It's last week. Last week.
It's live.
Well, maybe if we play Marbury again, we can have the same results.
I have to change it.
Tigers football.
Good snap, good hold.
It's good, it's good, it's good, it's good, it's good,
yes.
It's good.
Ready?
Yeah.
All right, you're up.
Back at Jay Hanna-Bryant Stadium this week, Tallassee Tigers football versus Chilton County here on WTLS. Score 94, hit 106, Tallassee Times TV through YouTube and Spectrum. Glad you're with us. Michael Butler with Philip Nelson, Stephen Oz Osborne, and Brad Davis at the stadium, as well as our Tiger Nation guys ready for a 7 o'clock kick tonight as we bring you the CB&S Bank countdown to kickoff. And Tallassee coming off of its first win of the season, a big one last week. They got hot with the offense, put 50 on the board, their most points in the game since the 2020 season, and a 50-34 win at Marbury. And the team they play tonight, they got a big one too last week, as they beat Calera 37-3. Chilton County, a guy that you will be watching tonight is their five-star linebacker who's now practicing his punts, DeMarcus Riddick. He's an Auburn commit. He originally selected Georgia verbally, and then he flipped, and an opportunity to come see one of the best players, not just in this state, but all over the country tonight. As we saw him last year when we played this same team up in Clanton, a game that went to overtime, a game that Tallassee thought they had won, a penalty erased a touchdown, and the Tigers fell in OT 24-21. We talked about that game and how we felt like that was a turning point for the Tigers, even in a loss, as they got hot after that and finished the season on a high note. Maybe last week was the beginning of that, and they can carry it over tonight versus the same team.
Yeah, you know, we talked about it this morning, Michael. You know, it's not often you get to come to ball field and see a five-star recruit, and most especially one that's like top five in the nation at his position. And so, you know, everybody's looking forward to seeing him, but I'm looking forward to see how our Tigers do, you know, and how we line up against him and how we play and, you know, what strategies we use to try to counteract his productiveness, because, I mean, he's going to be productive. I mean, that's why he's a five-star, but you got to try to kind of game plan around him, you know. And figure out blocking schemes to where maybe you can get him out to play so that your running backs and your quarterbacks can kind of get to work and gain some yardage. And, you know, last week we had a good output of offensive production last week. I didn't get to see it eye to eye, but I did listen to y'all, and it sounded like a pretty good ball game. And let's hope that we can continue that success on offense tonight here at home at J.E. Hot O'Brien Stadium.
I'm just ready for the sun to go down, man.
Yeah, I know that's
we're
right
in it. You know, it's, you hope. I know we talk about it. It shouldn't. This shouldn't. If you have to have something like this to motivate your team, then you're doing something wrong. But it really should. You shouldn't want somebody to come in here that's a 4 or 5 star and show out at your field. So I'm hoping and expecting these players and the coaches have schemed and have adapted their offense to fit around what our personnel can do now. So very exciting. We saw a lot of positives last week. We know what we've got to come out and do. I'm excited for it. It's going to be a good night.
It is warm, 83 degrees. We've had cooler temperatures, at least less humidity in the recent weeks. Thank goodness it's finally starting to feel a little bit like football weather, although football weather might just be 95 degrees for most of the season. Brad Davis down on the field. The shadows finally covering the turf. Yes, he'll be following the Tigers from the sidelines tonight.
Yeah, I think it was Oz just said something about the sun. Most of the time, you guys are in a little bit better shape than I am. But tonight, it's nice down here. We're in the shade. A little bit of a slight breeze. You know, it's been the talk all week. It's feeling more and more like fall every day. And yeah, but Michael, you just mentioned that. Don't know if we ever have real fall weather come football, but you know, it's getting closer to that time of the year. It's teams are down here. They're getting excited. Both of them are in here doing the kicking game, getting ready. Surface is in great shape. Not had much rain, but they've done a really good job keeping it keeping water on it. And I think this Tiger, I don't know when the last time was we had the Tiger, but it's looking good. Maybe I've missed it if we had it earlier. But it's ready to go. Field's ready to go. And the guys are getting ready to strap it up here in about an hour.
It's kind of crunchy, said Coach Battles. The turf has been dry. They water the grass every single day, but it's been hot and, well, no rain. And there's something about Mother Nature that
That's right.
is a little bit better than that stuff that we have to produce from the water system here. Nonetheless, we got two games in a row here on this field this week and homecoming next week, then two more on the road, and the final game will be senior night back here. So three of the next five are here as we are now about to hit the second half of this season.
It's always good to have that back half and have that home stretch here. You know, like you said, next three out of five is going to be here at home, and certainly, you know, you enjoy the home field advantage and everything, but, you know, we didn't get off to the best start in the first half, you know, but playoff contention is still alive because, I mean, you know, you still got Sylacauga, you still got some teams in the region here that you can hopefully match up with and to be able to play with, so, you know, maybe last Friday night was the turning point. Maybe that was the spark that they needed to kind of get going and to believe in themselves. And like I said a while ago, I just hope that you know, ignited our team and they can see that, okay, we can play football and come out here and play better than what we played early in the season.
You know, last year we went on a four-game losing skid after the first two wins, so we were 2-4 after the first six games. We win tonight, we get there. We ended up 7-5 and actually had a pretty good season and a good back half. Let's hope that that's the case as we move forward. If you are coming in tonight, Tallassee City Schools reminds you they have implemented a new policy for athletic events at home. And just to highlight those, if you are a student in the eighth grade or below attending the game, you must have a ticket and be accompanied by a paying adult or you will not be permitted into the facility tonight. Gathering around the concession stand or under around the bleachers is prohibited. Playing football or any other games in the grassy areas, the walkways, or the gravel areas around the football field is also prohibited. If you're caught playing, they will confiscate the football. Please find a seat. Watch the game. Do not stand along the fencing. These guidelines will be enforced by administrators and the police department. If you fail to follow the protocol, you will be asked to leave. So think about that as you're coming in tonight.
And I'm gonna speak out of turn right quick, but just allow me 1 minute.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be the bad guy here. Parents, people coming, don't badmouth the school or anything because that's a safety hazard. You've got all kinds of people, elderly, young, middle, whatever, coming in. You never know, and you don't want to hit anybody. So we all want to enjoy this and want to have a good time and want this to be a safe environment. So come on in, enjoy the game, watch the game, cheer your kids, your grandkids, nephews, nieces, whatever, band members, and have a good time. So
yes,
cheer
please.
These Tigers on.
Definitely so. We will take a quick break. Coach Mike Battles, the Tallassee Tiger Talk interview we had yesterday will come up next. We still got plenty more pregame, the CBNS Bank countdown to kickoff. Tallassee and Chilton County coming up on WTLS, Tallassee Times TV, and Spectrum.
We're proud of the Tallassee Tigers.
Tallassee Tiger Sports.
Pressure coming.
in all kinds of trouble. He's down. The game is over, and Tallassee's going to win it.
A WTLS tradition since 1954.
He's got him on his back. Oh, my gosh. There it is. Give him the pin.
Your home for the purple and gold.
They're going to fire up a three.
Yes, right. Hot as a firecracker. Here we go.
The Tallassee Tigers Sports Station.
In the center field, pretty well hit, deep, and it is gone.
WTLS, score 94 and hit 106.
And they're going to tag him out.
Oh. Look at this kid.
Causing a scene, needs to be ejected from the game after that. And now we got people about to go at him.
Man, how tacky.
Rub-a-dub-dub. Time to give the snub to that ugly tub. Time to contact Bath Innovations. With more than 30 years of providing families in the River Region with the very best bathroom remodels.
When you need a renovation without the aggravation, call Bath Innovations today.
Bath Innovations, ADA specialists, offer tub-to-shower conversions, walk-in tubs, grab bars, and bench seats, all backed by the Good Housekeeping Seal of Approval. View their design center on the Eastern Boulevard in Montgomery, or look them up at bathinnovations.com. It's time to make your bathroom beautiful and safe with Bath Innovations of Alabama.
At CBNS Bank, we've been family, community, and financially strong since we began in 1906. Our long history of stability is because we stay current. Gain financial freedom with the most sophisticated digital products. Check balances, pay bills, transfer funds, and deposit checks from anywhere. Make purchases on your mobile device using your CBNS Bank debit card with Mobile Wallet at participating stores and restaurants. Learn more at cbsbank.com. CBNS Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Charges and fees may apply from your cellular service provider. Contact your service provider for information.
Hi friends, it's Eric Cresswell here for Tallassee Ford Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram. We are proud to support Tallassee Tigers football. On behalf of our entire staff, we would like to thank all of our coaches and trainers for your time and the positive impact you have on our kids. Football teaches many life lessons like teamwork, discipline, respect, and both physical and mental health. When you're ready to purchase your next vehicle, please come by and let our hometown team help you. Shop our complete inventory at TallasseeAutomotive.com. Go Tigers!
Hello. This is Albert Elmore, your local State Farm agent. Guess what? We're in a new, bigger Tallassee location. Same great company, same licensed staff and agent. Contact us at 1311 Gilmer Avenue, next to Dairy Queen. Come by for a free quote, insurance review, or just call us at our same number, 283-2758.
There's a new vet clinic in Central Alabama. 4D Veterinary Services is now open on Highway 14 just past Heron's Crossroads. 4D is a full-service clinic with the latest state-of-the-art equipment. From x-rays to surgeries, you can rely on 4D. Open weekdays from 7:30 to 5:30. Appointments preferred, walk-ins welcome. 4DVet.com. On Facebook and Instagram. 4D Veterinary Services.
This is Tom Crane with Tallassee Rehab. This marks our 25th year in the Tallassee community, and this football season will be year 20 on the sidelines for our own Sterling Turner. At Tallassee Rehab, we're grateful for the relationships we've had over the past two-plus decades. Let our certified staff give you a hand with your injury. Tallassee Rehab, 1000 Friendship Road.
Hi, I'm Kari Sid, owner of Grove Station. We want to invite you to come in and join us for lunch, dinner, or brunch. We're open Tuesday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m., and we run dinner on Thursday and Friday nights from 5 p.m. to 8. Brunch is Saturday and Sunday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. We do private and hosted dining experiences in our loft. We're located in downtown Tallassee, Facebook, and Instagram. See you in a minute.
Don't worry, chillax. With Chillax Comfort Heating and Air, no matter the season, no matter the job, installs on new construction, service calls, or changeouts, contact Mac at Chillax. That's Mac Smith with 27 years in the business, and he's always on call. 24/7. Call 415-1188. Look him up on Facebook and be sure to like Chillax Comfort Heating and Air. Alabama license number 23205.
Hey, this is Jeremy Taunton with Tallassee True Value. Come by and see me, Dale Taylor, or Brad Roberts for all your building material needs. And if you need a paint color matched, we can do it with our state-of-the-art matching system. Tallassee True Value, we're local folks you've trusted since 1993. For all your hardware, lumber, paint, plumbing supplies, plumbing fixtures, windows, doors, nuts, and bolts, we've got it. And if we don't, we can get it for you. Tallassee True Value, 1400 Gilmer Avenue.
Neptune.
My name is Deron Laster. I work in Department 61. I've been here about 3 years. It's a great place to work, and I suggest anybody, if you're looking for a job, fill out an application. Go Tigers.
Neptune Technology Group, Tallassee, Alabama.
Countdown to kickoff.
Brought to you by CBNS Bank.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Tallassee Tiger Talk with Tallassee Tigers head football coach Mike Battles. We're just reminiscing about the good old days back when you were a player, both in college and high school. It's pretty good stuff back in the late 80s and early 90s.
I played against some of the best, you know. You read about them now, but a lot of them were teammates, and I got to play. You know, I played against Mike Tomlin, the head coach of the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Wow.
Played in a square toed shoe.
Yeah.
I mean, I never.
You never took it off. There's no reason.
I never took it off. I just wrapped it up and put it on there, and I just went out there and played linebacker. And when it came time, I punted in a square toed shoe, and then I place kicked in it. So it just made it a lot easier. You know, of course, those days, you know, there wasn't, you know, very few, if any, soccer style kickers. And then now that's all you see.
I don't know if you see any square toes anymore.
I haven't seen one
in the last 5 years or something.
I haven't seen too many. You know, you'll see them in high school.
Yeah.
A lot of times, you know, you won't, if you, you know, usually if you've got a soccer program, you're going to be able to, you know, we've been very fortunate that we've been able to get kickers the last many, many years from our soccer program. But, you just don't see it much anymore. It's old school and, that's just how it's gone.
You got one, Alec Carswell, as your kicker. That's where he came from, right? He's a soccer guy. I mean, pretty good kicker, too.
Before him, came from the soccer program. So, you know, we've got several kids. You know, our exchange student, Louise, he's a soccer player, but he wanted to come out and experience, you know, American football.
Yeah.
And we've been working him into the rotation, kicking extra points and stuff. So, hopefully, we're going to get an opportunity somewhere down the road to get him in a game and, you know, let him try one. We had plans to do it last week. Alec came up to me, you know, and asked, he said, hey, if we were to score again, because, you know, in that game last week, you never could get comfortable, you know, because it seemed like every time we got ahead three scores, they scored. Now they're back two scores, you know, that can happen quick. And you know, once we got to, you know, we got to 50, I felt comfortable enough. And Alec came up and asked me, you know, hey, could Louise kick one, you know? And
that's a nice thing to do, right?
For yeah, I mean, you know, they practice a lot together. And our team has really, you know, they've really enjoyed Louise and have really, you know, got to know him. And he's been a good addition to the team. So, you know, hopefully we're going to get an opportunity to get him out there and let him kick one.
Well, you speak of the range you had, about 50 yards as a high school kid. How far can – I know Carswell's kicked some pretty long, at least shown his foot. What about
got that kind of range, and every now and then, you know, you get a hold of one, just like when you're playing golf or something, you catch one. And you know, he's pretty confident, you know, in that range of 40 to give it the best shot to get through the goalpost.
Well, congrats. I haven't told you that on last week's win. I know it was tough. First four games were tough sledding, but get the monkey off the back with a win last week, and really, like you said, put the numbers on the board. It's the most points we scored in a football game in 3 years, 50 points in the win last week.
Yeah, it was, you know, I was happy for the kids because, you know, when you keep hearing the same old thing, just keep working hard, something good's going to happen. You really need it to.
Yeah.
You know, and we needed it in the worst way. Our kids were excited. You know, they played hard during the game. We had a lot of people that did a lot of good stuff. You know, I think we had four or five different people score touchdowns. Trent threw two touchdowns. You know, just a lot of people that contributed and got opportunities. Our offensive line did a good job blocking, you know, just a lot of good things. And, you know, when you have a total team victory like that and everybody gets to contribute, you know, it usually adds to your practices this week, you know, because everybody knows, hey, I may get an opportunity, you know. And, you know, the only downside of that is that we just didn't play real solid defense, and a lot of that had to do is that we just didn't tackle real well. And we've really worked on that the past 2 weeks. You know, we've done some stuff like live tackling, which we don't normally do. And, you know, it's hopefully we get that cleaned up.
Check, 1-2. Testing, 1-2. 1-2, test, 1-2-3, testing. Test 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. Check 1. Test 1. Test 1, 2, 3.
Several good receivers. They've got a really big H-back tight end type guy. And, then on the other side of the ball, on offense, we're going to continue to spread it around and try to get as many people involved in the offense. Obviously, Trent's doing a good job. You know, there's some things he's got to get corrected. But, you know, like I told you last week.
1-2, 1-2, testing.
You know, it's nice when you can have a year or two as a backup quarterback. It's a whole new ball game when you get thrown out there to the Wolves and you have to learn on the job. You know, here's the ball, go out there and do something with it. And he's done a great job with that. And our other players around him, I think, have helped out and continue to make plays when he does get the ball to him. And so. And he plays like it. You know, a lot of times you hear all these five stars and you go out there and you're like, oh, he doesn't really stick out. This guy will. He'll stick out when you look down there and look at him. And he sticks out. You know, last year he played and he was, if the offense, he was the right outside linebacker. Defense, he was left, you know, it's opposite. But, you know, we had plans where we could get away from him. You know, we could run to the other side. Well, now they figured that out and they put him right in the middle. And he plays all over the place. And, you know, of course, you know, he's a top priority with our offense this week. We have a lot of, you know, different things we can do and checkoffs and checking plays, depending on where we see him. Because now he's a good player, and they've got several other good players. And so, you know, it's going to be a challenge. They're a bigger school than us. It's going to be a challenge. And it sure beats going into that game with a W than it does with a L. So I think that'll give us some momentum. And our kids, you know, our kids have continued to work and improve the whole year. You know, you can go back and look at the films, and you can see the improvements that we've made along the year. And so, if we can improve as much this week as we did last week going into the game, then I feel pretty good about it. You know, we're healthy for the first time. Got everybody, got Christian back. You know, he's been out since the Real Town game with a high ankle sprain. Joseph Hooks has been dinged up. You know, he had a high ankle sprain. Now, he's played in most of the games, but couldn't go full speed. You know, so to get those guys back full speed, I think Christian, he had 140, 150. 50, I can't know the exact, but I know he scored 2 touchdowns on 12 carries, so he means a lot to our offense. You know, so to get everybody back and have everybody, and we've actually gotten more kids playing now. You know, we've got guys, Walker Wells that moved here from Hernando, Mississippi a year ago. He had been here before, and reps. We just got a lot of folks that are rotating in, and the more we can continue to do that and rest our starters, but still have a quality person who knows what to do out there, the better off we're going to be down the road.
Yeah. The offense last week, like you said, getting the ball in playmakers' hands, it happened on the very first play. I think that set the tone. You know, sometimes you draw up a play, it looks great, but you got to execute it. And it was a great throw and a great catch. Obviously, Trent, he has an arm that, it's really, I don't know if you've seen arms like this. You've had freshman quarterbacks, but it's just a beautiful ball that he throws.
It's natural.
Isn't it something?
We tend to use the term, he spins it pretty good.
He does, yes.
He throws a really good ball. He's just going to, it's going to be fun watching him over these next years. You know, we knew Tyler was going to be special, but you know, Tyler's ninth grade year, he went through a lot of, interception here, that kind of stuff, because it was the same deal with him. You know, we show up out there, he's a ninth grader, we don't really have anybody else that can, you know, do it. And so, you know, you stuck him in there knowing that, you know, he's gonna have to learn and he's gonna make some mistakes and you're just gonna have to deal with it, but he's the best you've got. And so Trent's done a good job, and Trent is one of those, he's a fun kid to be around and always got a smile on his face. And so our kids tend to rally around that, and he's doing a good job, and they're doing a good job for him.
You know, last year, you and I talked about this last year, but it seemed like the turning point of the season when we got on a run was this game against Chilton County, a game where we were down at halftime. Right. We came back. We had the win, but they wiped it out with a penalty, ended up losing in overtime. But from that point forward, the team just got better and better. Do you think maybe last week could have been that turning point for us, the way things kind of got in sync?
Well, I think it's two different things. You know, last year, it was more of an attitude and more of, I think, during those 3 or 4 weeks that we had in the season after coming out and beating Real Town and BTW, you know, I think we had a very selfish attitude. I'm just going to be honest with you. I think we had a lot of people pointing fingers after we lost to Clay Central, and then that continued on and continued on. What happened after the Chilton County game last year, you know, our kids went in the locker room. We had several seniors that kind of, you know, spoke out and said, guys, we're better than this. You know, we're not showing as good as we could be. And it's time it stops. You know, it's time that we quit listening to the noise, that we stop worrying about who gets to do what and how many times they get to carry it and this, that, and other. And, you know, we start playing as a team. And I think that's the difference. That was a different thing. This team's never been like that. This team has stayed together, has played hard, has continued to improve, has continued to have a good attitude and come to practice and do those things. So, you know, time will only tell, you know, if this was the turning point. I sure hope it is, you know. But it was two different situations, you know. This bunch, you know, I just told, you know, 2 weeks ago, we're in there practicing, and, you know, to this day and time with all the social media criticism that you get, if you can get a group of 15 through 18-year-olds to come out there, still have a great attitude, and they're sitting at 0-4, then, you know, you feel good about the team. You know, you want them to have success. We want to win every game when we step out on the field. It just hadn't worked out that way. And, you know, but I'm proud of these kids because they've just continued to work, continued to just drown out everything else, and continue to play with each other. And I think you saw a good, you know, a good – you know, I guess, attitude and how the kids were operating last week. You know, we had so many people make plays. And so, you know, it's that really makes things good.
You know, you bring up the social media aspect. And this week on our Lindy's Football Report, which we carry every Thursday night, Sam Pittman was talking about this past week, talking about college football. An Arkansas kicker, or punter, actually, was down and out because of some of the stuff that was on social media. And they got into, you know, the conversation about how people – just say anything they want out there and don't really give it a care at all about young kids involved here. Well, now, same case here, right?
I mean, that's the big thing. That is why I think social media is the worst thing that's happened to team sports. I'll say it to anybody. You know, they can say all they want to about me. I mean,
That's what Pittman said, basically. You know, I don't care if they say I'm fat, you know, or whatever.
It doesn't matter to me. I'm this, I'm that. That's fine. I'm an adult. It's what I am.
Yeah.
When you start talking about 15, 16, 17, 18-year-olds, and they see it, and yes, it has an effect on them. I mean, they spend, you know, 23 hours and 59 minutes looking at those phones.
Right.
And, you know, and so when they see it, you know, everybody, you know, they want people to say nice things about them. So, you know, it's difficult this day and time. You know, we call them Facebook warriors, those guys that are real tough on Facebook, you know, but it's a shame, but our kids have done a good job, you know, dealing with, you know, maybe some of the negativities. There's been a lot of positives this year. We've had a lot of people that have shown a lot of support. A lot of the mothers, team moms, have come up there and done things for the team and, you know, brought them Gatorades and stuff like that. And I think when they see those things, that's very important because that's coming from the community, and it's letting them know that, hey, you know, we're sticking with you. We're in this, you know. Y'all just keep playing hard and something good's going to happen. So that's kind of where we are.
One more thing on Chilton County. Last week, they probably played their best game. I know you looked at the film. They dominated Calera. And Calera's had kind of a tough year. It's hard to know, though. You said they're playing 6A football. We don't know how good these teams are.
They're playing. I do.
Yeah.
And they're playing really good football.
Right. Games, and 37-3 last week. So they put it all together, obviously, with their second win. But and you mentioned Riddick. How often have you coached against a guy that's got those kind of accolades? It's very rare to see a 5-star play. I know he's 4-star in some spots and 5 in others, but everybody wanted this guy.
I don't know how many stars, and I don't know who gives them to him. Probably somebody that's never played a game but has a magazine.
It's possible. You
know? But I tell you what he is. He's a very rare individual to have the size he has and to be able to move like he can. I mean, he returns kickoffs. You know, he's on the kickoff return team back there as one of the returners. You know, he's a special talent. You know, just like the kid, you know, we played, you know, BTW's got a big outside linebacker. You know, it's like this. If you've been around football and been around sports, it doesn't take you long to look out on that field and you can pick them out.
Yeah.
You know, you can pick those guys out because they stick out no matter where they go, you know. And so he's just one of those. He's a really good player. He's like the kid from Charles Henderson, you know, the 10th grader they got that's a 5-star, 4-star, whatever. You know, they're just really good players, and they have, you know, they have God-given ability and size and talent and speed and all those things. And a lot of it you can't coach or teach. A lot of it you're born with, you know. I've played against some or coached against some throughout the years. But now to see the whatever, you know, I guess the term 5-star, see one like that, that doesn't come along often.
Yeah. There's a policy that's been put into place, the school put, for football games, home games. It didn't look like it had really changed much from what we already had in place. Could you just kind of highlight that?
I don't know. What
basically, kids can't play in the grassy areas with a football. You can't linger around the concessions.
I didn't have anything.
Okay. I mean, you're working on the field,
but,
right?
But, I mean, yeah, I'm out there, you know, on the inside of the fence. But I think those things, you know, we are police officers and administration and stuff have always tried, you know, to, you know, the more orderly you have, the less chance you have of having an issue in the exactly. stands.
And there have been problems with that this year in other places.
So whatever they've done, I'm sure it's for the best, and I'm sure it was for reasons that we've already had to deal with before. So, yeah.
All right. Well, you can read it, folks. It's on Facebook on the Tallassee City Schools page. Coach, thank you very much. We will see you Friday night.
Hey, see y'all tomorrow night.
Thank you.
Tiger.
The wake-up call.
I got on a website and found this jacket for $11.99. This is a $12 jacket with a dollar tax. Free shipping. This is $13, man. I'm telling you, I got one more.
It looks like a $13.
Get out of here.
Chris Plant.
It's a filthy, corrupt city, Washington, D.C., and our government is very corrupt. It's like East Germany during the Cold War level corruption here.
River Region Sports.
I know of a couple of coaches who have already said, I've had enough. They don't want to fool with it anymore. They said, the money ain't worth it. When you're putting in 70-hour weeks every week.
Chuck Oliver.
Tallassee? Tallassee. Tallassee Tigers. I coached there one night when I was with Notasauga.
WTLS. Score 94 and hit 106. Rock and Jocks.
Hospice services are considered the model for quality, compassionate care for people facing a life-limiting illness. At Community Hospice Care, it is our desire that you and your loved ones receive excellent care at the end of life's journey. As your only locally owned and operated nonprofit hospice, we strive daily to make a difference in the quality of life that you have. We provide expert medical care, pain management, nursing assistant care, emotional and spiritual support expressly tailored to the patient's needs and wishes. When a patient is admitted to hospice, we also pay for the patient's medications and supplies related to their diagnosis. Support is provided to a patient's loved one as well. Community Hospice Care can provide care in a patient's home, nursing home, or assisted living. Our team includes expert medical doctors, nurses, social workers, chaplain services, and so much more. Because we are your local hospice agency, all of our staff is local. This means fast on-call response time for you and your loved one. Community Hospice Care of Tallassee. Compassionate care in difficult times.
Hi, this is Brad Mason, City President of First Community Bank of Central Alabama. I would like to take this opportunity to invite each of you to stop by and visit us at one of our two convenient locations in the Tallassee community. We are located at 526 Gilmer Avenue and at 28 Neptune Road. Our friendly staff will be happy to help you with any of your financial needs. We have a wide variety of deposit products such as checking, savings, money market, and CDs. If you're wanting to buy a boat or automobile or thinking of refinancing your home, come see one of our loan officers, and we'll be glad to assist you. First Community Bank has been serving the Tallassee community for over 7 years. We are your locally owned hometown community bank. Please call us at 283-2299 or visit us on the web at fcbca.com.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Football and barbecue. What a combination. When it's football and Maypop's barbecue, you know you've got a winner. When you're planning for the game, be sure to mix in some Maypops. Pre-order at maypopsbarbecue.com. Pick up at their East Tallassee location on Notasauga Road or at their food truck. See the schedule by following Maypops on Facebook. Maypops, wood-fired barbecue, the fan favorite.
If you're involved in an auto accident, City Collision can help. Contact Dana Haynes. Dana has 3 decades of experience with paint and body work. From minor fender benders to major repairs, see Dana for a lifetime warranty on all repairs. Insurance claims welcome. And City Collision offers truck accessories. Located on the Tallassee Highway, just past the Y, City Collision.
Hey, it's Brad Parker.
And Jamie Bush at Parker Tire and Service Center.
It's tailgating time. Don't let car troubles ruin your road trips.
Let us help you with new Michelin, Uniroyal, BF Goodrich, and Toyo tires.
Whether you're headed to the big game or just across town, change your oil, lube, and filter.
And don't forget a checkup for your engine.
Parker Tire and Service Center.
1508 Gilmer Avenue in
I'm fine in my left here.
Here's Mark Bell. It's on mine. Exciting news from Bell Contracting.
Yeah, we've opened up a new group in our business, installing swimming pools, and we've really enjoyed some success with it.
I know this is the season to start putting in the pools as we move out of pool season.
Kind of funny you bring that up, because pool season for us is this time of year. We're doing pools that will fit basically any budget. We've got them from 10 feet long all the way up to 60 feet long.
How do they get in touch with you?
Bell Contracting on Facebook, bellcontractingllc.com on the internet. We'd love to visit with you.
Football and tailgating, two great traditions in the South. Here's another one that makes them better. Shopping at Tallassee Superfoods. Stock up on great tailgating items that make football watching even better. And if you're the host of a big party on Saturday, do it right with great steaks or boneless chicken breast or a grilling favorite, smoked sausage. Throw on the fixins and you're ready for football. Get it all at cost plus 10% at either location. Tallassee Superfoods on Gilmer Avenue or on Notasoga Road in East Tallassee.
Wherever you want to fly, the Montgomery Regional Airport wants you to get there. With nonstop destinations to Atlanta, Charlotte, Dallas, and Washington, D.C., MGM is your gateway to adventure. Visit flymgm.com to book your next experience.
I'm Eli Gold. Roll with the Tide on Score 94 and Hit 106.
Well, the bands have made their way in. Tallassee's Pride of Tallassee has found their seats. And you can hear the Chilton County Marching Band making their way up as well, as we're about 30 minutes, well, actually a little bit less than that, away from the kickoff. We continue the CBNS Bank countdown to kickoff. And look at some scores from games that were played last night. There were a few. And what we have on tap for tonight. It was a game at Crampton Bowl, won the Graham Gun call today, the worst game he had ever seen in high school football history. Selma and Park Crossing.
Funny.
The final score was 6-0 Park Crossing. He was the PA guy last night at Crampton Bowl. My apologies to Graham for having to witness that. Sorry for those two teams that he said that about.
Oh, yeah.
Macon East played Crenshaw last night, and it was Crenshaw Christian with a victory 29-0. We have some games on tap tonight, also on the AISA, Edgewood and Banks. It's in the AHSA, Realtown taking on Cleburne County, going all the way up to Cleburne County in Heflin tonight. Alabama Christian is on the road, not too far for them, in Montgomery at Montgomery Academy. Charles Henderson and St. James also playing in the capital city tonight. As we mentioned, a battle of two teams that reached state championship games in their respective classes. Charles Henderson, the runner-up in 5A last year, and St. James, of course, was the winner in 3A last year as well. Marbury on the road, the team we played last week. They're at Trinity in Montgomery. A lot of games in the capital city conference tonight. Hopeful goes to West Blockton. It is Catholic playing at Demopolis. Elmore County homecoming in Eclect tonight. They got St. Clair County as the opponent. Eclectic, of course, Elmore County. The Panthers were off last week, and they'll be our opponent for homecoming next week here in Tallassee. Wetumpka's at Greenville. Lanier goes to Jasper. Percy, Julian, and Carver try to up the game they had last night at Crampton Bowl with a couple of Montgomery teams. Stanhope is on the road at Prattville. And, of course, our game here, Chilton County and Tallassee. Two teams with losing records coming in. Chilton County's 2-3 on the season. Tallassee is 1-4. Last week, the Tigers winners over Marbury and Marbury, 50-34. And Chilton County beat Galera 37-3. We mentioned the game last year they played was an overtime affair, won by Chilton County, the home team, 24-21.
Rip off.
Yeah.
It is something, I tell you, it's got to be tough. It's tough to lose, but it's tough to lose when you thought you celebrated a win, a penalty flag brought back the play, and ended up being a loss in the end.
And
that's
still
what it was last year.
I still think it was a, I don't know, picky call, because he did not turn up field. Anyway, it's in the past.
Yeah, it can't do nothing about it now.
That's right.
So, but it like, y'all are correct. It's hard to swallow when you lose like that. But hopefully we'll have a little bit better results here tonight on our home field.
See the anglers, the fishing team, getting recognized here at J.E. Heidebride Stadium. And Coach Philip Nelson, who's with us here this week, is a part of that. That's where you were last week.
I was, indeed. I'm a part of this year's team. That's last year's team right there. They won the state championship last year in Alabama High School athletics for bass fishing. And so they're getting recognized for that tonight.
Congratulations to them. You know, I had some fun. Steve Stokes, I know you're here tonight. He just messaged me. He said he and the Stokes family and the Watsons are here watching. He had messaged me last week while you were away, and I mentioned in the intro that you were here. You're on the road with this team. You were not with us. And he says, what happened to Phillip? So I told him you had been suspended. You were on a one-game suspension. And
yes.
We had some fun with that, but he immediately contacted you and found out that you were actually with this fishing team.
Yeah, I was. We had a good time up at Lake Neely Henry. Let's see, we had a couple of guys, Michael Markham and Carter Davison last week actually finished in the top 10 in that tournament. It had 150-plus boats in it, and so they did really well. And we had two other boats that finished in the top 25, so we had a pretty good showing for our first tournament. But that was a different trail last week. This week, tomorrow starts the trail that we won last year.
Yeah.
So I'm hoping we do good tomorrow on right here on our home lake, on Lake Martin.
Look, it's awesome what they're doing for the kids nowadays, because back in the day when we were in school, you'd have never thought about a fishing team. I'm glad that they've come up with all the
kids. Yeah. We've been able to recognize some of these different athletes in different sports, different times of the year in most cases that have come out and in the pregame done this, and that's nice that we're able to do that. I know Phillip's been with the fishing team some this fall, and you have, Oz, been following the volleyball team. You've got a daughter that plays, and this past week they were pretty busy too.
They were, yeah. Went up to Hopeville, played up there in Marbury last week. It's fun. I'm softball and volleyball, and, man, it's exciting. I never would have thought it. Who would have thunk it? I never would have thought about being that excited and that into games as volleyball and softball. It's fun. Come out and support these young ladies whenever you get a chance.
And we'll get a chance here to promote another event that's coming up involving the soccer team. I know it's not soccer season, but they've already had tryouts, and Coach Matthew Tarpley's got a lot of kids participating in all the different levels. We got a varsity boys, a varsity girls, and a JV team. And a fundraiser for them is going to be a haunted house event, which is coming up. And we've shared some of this on Tallassee Times. You can look at TallasseeTimes.com and read the article. And there's a share today about tickets. It's coming up in the month of October, a haunted house. Obviously, Halloween's coming up. And it'll be at the guest house. That's going to be fun. People can go and be a part of that and also support the Tallassee soccer program at the same time. They have shared that. You can read more about it. Go to Facebook or just go straight to the website at TallasseeTimes.com. We'll take another break as the dance team performs here for the crowd that's gotten here so far. Still plenty of seats available. Come by and join us. Tallassee Tigers football versus Chilton County coming up on WTLS, Score 94 and Hit 106.
You want Bama.
You got it.
Touchdown!
The Tide plays here.
A corner, a three-pointer, perfect.
The Alabama Crimson Tide.
Here comes the throw to the plate. It is late, and Alabama takes a 2-0 lead.
Roll with the Tide.
We love it that you love Alabama, and I'll just say roll Tide to you.
Right. On WTLS, Score 94 and Hit 106.
Better back down. You're in my domain. Got the whole crowd screaming out.
All of us at HDD Broadband are extremely proud to offer our state-of-the-art fiber-to-the-home network. We are now offering residential packages which consist of 250 megabytes for $65 a month, 500 megabytes for $75 a month, 1 gig for $95 a month, and 2.5 gigs for $165 a month. We've lowered our residential rates as we committed to in 2022 and have incorporated a 1 gig service and a 2.5 gig service for residential and commercial customers. Current customers may call and adjust their data packages if they wish or enjoy their new adjusted rate based on their current service. Please give us a call at 334-430-0049 to apply for service and information on our new rates. You may add us on Facebook at HDD Broadband to stay up to date on our current locations and updates on pre-registration. Feel free to view our webpage at hddbroadband.com.
Another Guardian Credit Union story.
Hey, so what are we doing with your hair today?
I need a trim.
a new dishwasher, and a much-needed vacation. Do you see any grays?
Sounds like you need a personal loan. My friend just got a loan from Guardian Credit Union, and he used it to upgrade his kitchen appliances.
That's what I need to do.
Guardian has great rates and a friendly team that makes payments affordable.
Perfect. I guess stylists really can fix everything.
Connect with Guardian for all your lending needs.
Federally insured by NCUA. Equal housing opportunity. NMLS number 912757.
Tallassee's leading florist is Godwin's Flowers. In the same location since 1971 in the East Tallassee Shopping Center. Godwin's Flowers are always fresh and always the highest quality for any occasion. Delivering to most of the surrounding area. Open from 8 to 4 weekdays, except Wednesdays, and from 8 to 11 on Saturdays. Godwin's Flowers. Flowers with a personal touch in the East Tallassee Shopping Center.
People are talking about revived traditions. It's not football or baseball or basketball, not soccer, volleyball, or lacrosse, but it goes with any sport. It's Louie's Chicken Fingers, 1410 Gilmer Avenue in Tallassee. Louie's has chicken fingers, wings, catfish, hush puppies, fresh veggies, salads, wraps, and more. Catering is available too. Specials and updates on Facebook at Louie's of Tallassee. Before the game, after the game, anytime is Louie's time. Louie's Chicken Fingers, 1410 Gilmer Avenue, 991-4367.
This is Clay Brantley at Eagle Motor Group. We wish you'd come by and just see what inventory we got. If we don't have what you need, let us know and we'll see if we can find it. We're glad to be back in Towson. We just want to thank everybody for all the support.
This is Eric Gill here at Eagle Motor Group. Just want to let everybody know that we are a preferred dealer for Guardian, Max, and Alabama State. And 99% of our vehicles are sold under NADA retail.
Come by and see us at 1010 Gilmer Avenue.
Right here in Tallassee. Go Tigers.
With football season here, you know what that means. Christmas is not far off. Your kids have been asking for a four-wheeler, or motorcycle, or even a go-kart. Simply Southern Acres on Highway 229, just 2 miles off the Tallassee exit, has 60cc motorcycles with training wheels to 250cc four-wheelers. Put it on layaway, and they'll hold it for the big day. Simply Southern Acres, your power sports dealer. Call 399-0546.
Here's the deal. Combining your home and auto insurance with State Farm can help save you money. My name is Logan Steers, and our office is ready to help you combine your auto and home insurance right here in Tallassee. Drop by our office today at 1409 Gilmer Avenue or visit our website for a free quote at logansteers.com.
Hornsby & Son Body Shop.
My dad picked it up as a hobby when he was still in the Navy. Once he got out, I followed along with him. We have a great staff. The technology is evolving practically every day. 15, 20 years ago, you know, you would see a concurrence of a same year model car run 5, 6, 7 years. Now they basically change every year. You have to keep up with that technology and kind of move forward.
Hornsby & Son Body Shop, 101B Caldwell Street in East Tallassee.
We're talking with Jason Spain of Sepulchre Tree Service. Jason, no matter the size of the project, you can do it all.
That's right, Michael. From a large removal to trimming a few limbs off of a encroaching tree on your roof line to fence rows.
Sepulchre Tree Service is licensed and insured with reasonable pricing.
That's correct, Michael. Sometimes there's a misnomer that, you know, I can't afford to have this tree removed, but it's probably more affordable than you think.
Sepulchre Tree Service. Jason, what's that number?
334-467-0083.
467-0083, Sepulchre Tree Service.
Are you in the market for a new home, selling yours, or would like to rent? Let Newstone Realty help you. We serve the Tri-County area, offering both sales and property management services. Visit our website for information on featured properties at newstonehomes.com. Newstone Realty, LLC, a member of the National Association of Realtors, Equal Housing Opportunity.
This is the CB&S Bank Countdown to Kickoff. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
You're up.
Let's check out the starting lineups projected for Tallassee tonight on offense and defense. At quarterback,
Trent Morris in the backfield. Running backs, Christian McCary, Jaden McKenzie, and Joseph Hooks. Wide receivers, Brody Ellis, Chase Chumley, and Walker Wells. The center, Joel Holcomb. The lineman, Jatwan Griffin, Braden Arnold, Ben Carwell, and John Jeffrey joining Holcomb. On defense, the line is A.J. Henry, Brandon Barrow, Eli Whittington. The linebackers, Christian McCary, Joseph Hooks, Caleb Segrist, and Carter Sayers. And the defensive backs, Jaden McKenzie, Rush Wright, and Cortland Roberts with Chase Chumley.
Lord, we ask that you will protect the players as well as everyone here tonight. Keep us safe on our way home. We love you, and it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Please join in our pledge to the United States flag. The pledge will be led tonight by the captain of the Pride of Tallassee, Jacqueline Sanchez.
Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We now ask that you join in singing as the Pride of Tallassee plays our national anthem.
Out of Tallassee, the national anthem. I want to say thank you to Jennifer Whittington, one of the moms of our football players. Of course, her son is Eli, and she brought up a thank you card. We appreciate that.
Oh, says, yeah.
The Tigers, we believe, and thank you for all you do. We are glad to do this, and we enjoy it, and we certainly appreciate you thanking us. It's our pleasure.
Yeah, we have fun with it. We talk about that all the time. We enjoy coming and doing the ball games and seeing these young men play, and just glad to give back to the community the best way we can. And hey,
man, I do it for the money. Michael pays me. I mean, wow.
Be quiet.
Exactly.
Oh,
we need to take one more break. The coin toss and the kickoff coming your way after this on WTLS Score 94 and Hit 106.
Do you know football?
Yeah.
Are you a prognosticator? Or do you pick winners based on the uniforms?
Oh, boy.
Regardless, it's worth giving your best shot. Why? There's cash prizes, and everybody's got a chance. Be a part of our football pick'em contest with a season-ending prize pot worth $1,500. Courtesy of Seppo Cane Tree Service. Money does grow on trees. Go to TallasseeTimes.com or 1300WTLS.com to play and for a full list of rules. Come on, get to picking. You could be a winner.
Happy pets. Happy customers at Urban Tales in Tallassee.
The staff at Urban Tales is amazing. They always do such a great job with Maddie when I take her to be groomed. They are professional, kind, and loving. We are blessed to have them in Tallassee.
We take our dogs to the daycare at Urban Tales, and they love it so much that I can't let them know where we are going until I'm ready to leave the house. Otherwise, they're going to rush me out the door.
My dogs Sophie and Sadie love Urban Tales, and they sleep great at night.
Come see us at Urban Tales, 305 Barnett Boulevard in historic downtown Tallassee.
My name is Tristan Moon, owner of Moon's Barbecue at 563 Jordan Avenue in Tallassee, Alabama. Moon started back in Talladega, Alabama in the 50s when my granddad ran it, H.G. Moon. Now we're bringing it to Tallassee to keep the Moon's tradition going. We like to bring great barbecue. We serve everything from pulled pork ribs, brisket, chicken, mac and cheese, baked bean, potato salad, coleslaw. We do a dessert of the week. We're also actively hiring. Please come see us at 563 Jordan Avenue, Tuesday through Saturday from 11 to 7.
Watch the pros work outdoors, and you'll see why they choose Husqvarna Power Equipment. For exceptional power and performance, superior precision, and amazing control. Perfect your landscape with the same precision, power, and performance demanded by the pros. Husqvarna, professionally proven outdoor power equipment.
Tallassee Power and Equipment, just past the Y on Highway 14 West.
Southeastern Insurance in Tallassee is a local independent agent that can save you money, residential or commercial. Let them find a competitive rate and start saving now. Autos and trucks, mobile homes, and your family lake property. Plus coverage for all of your summertime lake toys, Sea-Doos, boats, ATVs, RVs, and bikes. Call them for a quote on your fishing and hunting lodge. Keep it local and get local service. Southeastern Insurance, LLC in Tallassee. Call Roger Davidson or Star Cannon today, 334-283-4933.
Root your team on in style. The Tiger Paw has you covered with all new designs. Sports apparel right. For the ball player and the fan. The Tiger Paw has fundraising t-shirts and custom design, screen printed, vinyl, embroidery, and monogram, plus alterations. Custom apparel, sports equipment, and team spirit. The Tiger Paw. Open weekdays from 9 to 6 and Saturdays from 9 to 2. Like them on Facebook and visit them in downtown Tallassee at 101 Tess, South Ann Avenue. The Tiger Paw.
Instant news. Immediate availability.
Tallassee's one. They're going to elect to kick.
TallasseeTimes.com. Read it online. Follow it on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Stay up to date on all Tallassee news, sports, socials, classifieds, and photos. Plus, get live video on all social platforms and Tallassee Times TV on YouTube. Tallassee Times. TallasseeTimes.com.
WTLS Tallassee. Pike
so,
Road.
Hey, we're not on yet, right?
Score 94 and hit 106. Rock and jocks. Jocks.
Tallassee wins the toss and elects to kick, so they'll be defending the south end zone. Chilton County will be returning, defending the north end zone here in the first half as the two teams make their way onto the field here at J.E. Hyderabad Stadium. And we're ready for football. Tallassee and Chilton County coming up. This has been the CBNS Bank Countdown to kickoff, and the kick is coming up next.
It looked to me like the official did that when he hit us.
I don't know.
Or 18 minutes. Does it make a difference if they're made by a machine in a factory or made by hand by a single person? Hardee's made from scratch biscuits with caramel, icing, and crumb topping, because there's nothing fresh about frozen biscuits.
Neptune.
My name is Ryan Nichols. I work in the foundry. I've been at Neptune for 3 years, and one of the best things about working here is everybody's working for the same goal, to win their day.
Neptune Technology Group, Tallassee, Alabama.
Join me, Chris Plant, weekday mornings at 9 on Score 94 and Hit 106.
Tallassee will be kicking off as we get ready to go here at J.E. Hyderabad Stadium. Chilton County, the opponent tonight. Their coach is Marvin Morton. He's in his second season. His record is 6-9 in two seasons, his third overall as a coach, 11-15. Mike Battles, 12th year at Tallassee, 78-49 at THS. His 27th year in coaching as a head coach, he has a 195-104 record. Alec Carswell has the whistle, and he will do the fake and back up to kick. Back deep is Justin Godwin, one of the captains for Chilton County, alongside Donald Jackson. And the kick is a swift kick that will be picked up at the 30-yard line and returning it out to the 39 and taking a big blow is Hunter Ousley. Chilton County will have it there first and 10.
Yeah, tackle made by number 99, Walker, Michael Walker for the Tallassee Tigers. on that return. And like you said, that was a pretty good collision to start with right there, Michael.
Hear the fans popping already.
Yes.
Coach Mike Battles told us on the scouting report that Chilton County likes to throw the football. And we will expect that tonight as they'll go with the trips formation. Three receivers to the right. They'll bring Oosley in motion. The quarterback is Logan Coppage. He will take it. He will hand it off and right up the middle. The running back out across the 45 to the 46 is Donald Jackson, and he picked up about 6 yards on first down.
Yeah, Chilton County did a nice job opening up a hole on the left side and picked up good yardage right there. We're going to have to do a little bit better closing our gaps and filling our gaps.
Second and four. Jackson again, right side of the offensive line. He's up close to the first down near the 50-yard line.
I know he still picked up three or four, but we did a little bit better with our gap assignment on that play, Michael. And a while ago, he really didn't get touched until he got past the defensive line. But this time, we actually got a little bit of a hand on him. So
they marked him short as third down.
Yep.
Less than a yard, though. They need the other side of the 50. Quarterback sneak, and that should do it. Coppage takes it himself, and that will move the chains.
Seemed like you mentioned something about a quarterback sneak this Monday with Alabama football, didn't you?
I think I was not the only one, yes.
Okay, well, there you go. You just saw one. I know it wasn't your Alabama football team, but we got to see one tonight.
And first down.
It is a first down.
From the 49 of Tallassee, Jackson again, right up the middle. This time they grab him after he got a yard to the 48.
That's a good play defensively by the Tallassee Tigers. Number four, Christian McCary, met him in the hole, him and Caleb Segris, and did a nice job of sealing him off to allow the rest of the defense to come up and help make that play. The defensive line did a good job. Eli Whittington, Vincent Diego right there, Braden Arnold, they did a good job on that left side of the defensive line to clog up that hole so our linebackers can make the play.
Little jet sweep to
that was a hold.
Some room for Binion. He's out across the 30. There is a flag. He goes out of bounds inside the 20-yard line, but this one probably coming back.
Yeah, this one's going to come on back, and we're going to redo this play. Oz was correct on his assessment that there was a hold. I think everybody tried to throw the flag on that one because it was pretty blatantly obvious.
Well, it would have been a big first down. Instead, it'll be second and long. They'll back them up back into Chilton County territory.
Yeah, and I think that, you know, the hold is what helps spring him loose because, I mean, kind of held our guy over there where we couldn't make a play.
Back to the 44 of the Chilton County Tigers. Second down and about 19.
Our defensive ends has got to do a good job. When they do that jet sweep like that, they got to do a good job of sealing off so they don't get turned inside. They've got to stay outside the play so that they can force a run back inside where your help's at.
Fake it to him this time and look to pass and go down the field on a post route. The ball is too long. Incomplete. Roberts back in coverage for Tallassee as they were trying to hook up with receiver Cooper, and it will be third and long.
That was basically just an old post route is what he was running. And like you said, Cortland Roberts, number 11, was on the coverage for Tallassee. But, you know, Coach Battle said they would air it out. And so.
Might be looking to throw it again here on third down and long.
Yeah, that number 9 is who I was kind of watching pregame. Had good hands, and he's a big target for that quarterback.
He's lined up in the slot with three receivers over there this time, one on the right side. They're looking right, trying to set up a screen. They do to Jackson, but right there to make the play was Tallassee's Joseph Hooks stopping him for a short gain. It'll be fourth down.
Man, that was a good read by Joseph Hooks, number 2 for the Tallassee Tigers. He saw that play setting up. And he just basically sat down and kind of waited for that play to develop to make sure that he got a good open field tackle and force a punt on the first series for the Tallassee Tigers.
George Castilla will go back to do the kicking. Back to return is Chase Chumley for Tallassee. Whistles Coach Battles wants a timeout. 8:32 to go in this first quarter. No score. We'll take a break.
Hi, this is Brad Mason, City President of First Community Bank of Central Alabama. I would like to take this opportunity to invite each of you to stop by and visit us at one of our two convenient locations in the Tallassee community. We are located at 526 Gilmer Avenue and at 28 Neptune Road. Our friendly staff will be happy to help you with any of your financial needs. We have a wide variety of deposit products such as checking, savings, money market, and CDs. If you're wanting to buy a boat or automobile or thinking of refinancing your home, come see one of our loan officers and we'll be glad to assist you. First Community Bank has been serving the Tallassee community for over 7 years. We are your locally owned hometown community bank. Please call us at 283-2299 or visit us on the web at fcbca.com.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Keep up with the latest. Like and follow WTLS and Tallassee Times on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram.
I don't know who's number 12 now. Oh, that's weird.
Chumley returns and downed at the 17-yard line after the punt. I thought that Castillo might have taken a knee back there when he went down to get it, but there was no whistle. Could have been a big break for Tallassee. Chumley, the ball popped out. Not sure if he was down. We did cover it up either way. We got it first down. The first play will go right side with Hooks. Hooks with a stiff arm to get across the 20 and takes it up to the 24. Nice gain on first down by Joseph Hooks of about 7.
Good hard run on the right side by Joseph Hooks. They did a nice job of getting out here, turning the defensive end in. It gave Joseph a chance to pick up a few yards. And like I say, good pickup, 7 yards on first down.
Tallassee put 50 on the board last week in the win at Marbury, their first victory of the season. And they scored on their first play from scrimmage. That was a pass play. Here's a second and three coming up from their own 24. Morris will give it to Chumley going left. He's got some room. He's going to get, it looks like, the first down as he got up to about the 27. And then second effort probably would definitely at least look like move the chains.
Yeah, it looks like he got enough for the first down. Michael, good play. Good hard run by Chase Chumley. Nice to see.
They do move him, and it is Tallassee's first down after a couple of plays from scrimmage.
Had a young man just limp off. Might have been Battles. I think he's wearing 12 tonight.
Yeah.
So.
Four receivers, two on each side for Trent Morris, the freshman. He will take it himself. Running play right up the middle of the defense, across the 35. Strangled as he's taken down at about the 38. They say move the chains again, 11 yards.
And tackled by you-know-who. We just wonder when we'd call his name tonight, number 6.
He is a big guy.
And he's playing safety.
Yeah, interesting to see him back there, how much bigger he is. He's 6'3", 225.
And normally he plays linebacker, don't he? Like,
normally, yes. Got him playing deep right now. They got some pretty big linebackers to match, though.
They saw us throwing the ball deep last week.
Hand off a jet sweep to Chumley. Chumley slips as he tries to cut back across the 40. Still a pretty good gain of 3 or maybe 4 yards, depending on that spot.
Tackle once again made by number 6, DeMarcus Riddick on the play.
We'll say it was 3, 2nd and 7 at the 41 of Tallassee, their first possession of the night.
To be 6'3", 225, he's got pretty good closing speed.
There's a reason why he's a 5-star by some of those recruiting services. Morris, it's the quarterback run again. Left side he goes across the 45 up to the 46. And will leave Tallassee with a third down and short after he picked up 5. Third and a couple of yards to go.
Yeah, good hard run by Trent. Our offensive line's doing a good job, guys. They're doing a good job of opening up some holes for us. Looks like Trent's trotting off.
Going to go Wildcat now.
Yeah, with Joseph.
Yeah, this is probably 4-down territory if he doesn't get it here. Third down. Run left. First down. Midfield. They try to strip it out of there. He holds on to it, though. It will be another Tallassee first down, and we'll mark it up around the 50-yard line.
Yeah, number six on the tackle again, Reddick. Or Riddick, excuse me, depending on what side.
You better get used to it. You're going to be calling out his name as an Auburn Tiger.
Yeah.
Soon.
According to which side the bridge on, Riddick, you know.
I got it.
Pronunciation, Norrell, you know, those kind of things.
Hey, guys, when he arrives, he has really, really bad intentions.
Yes, I have noticed.
He arrives with authority.
A bad snap. Trent picks it up, though. Swings it out to McCary. Nice catch. Riddick's going to get him and take him down the backfield, though. Yeah, that one kind of got a slow start. And ends up being a 2-yard loss. Not much you could do one-on-one with Riddick on the other side of you. Second and 12, Tigers now at their 48.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm sorry, he did good just to get the ball up and be able to even follow through with a play.
And off to McCary. Nice move as he puts his head down and gets inside the 45 to the 44 of Chilton County. A good run on second down, which gives us a manageable third down.
Yeah, and at least it makes it third and short, Michael. You know, we were way behind the sticks. It was, what, second about 12, 13? So good hard pickup for the Tallassee Tigers. And we certainly got to be in four down territory right here.
Yeah, third down at about 3.
Big hole, offensive line blocked well.
It's the Wildcat again with Hooks back there. He runs right, jumps over one man, and then falls forward. He's going to pick up only a yard in his fourth down, about 2 yards to go for Tallassee. And here comes Trent Morris back onto the field.
Their nose tackle is a sizable young man, number 66.
Very.
You know, Joel ain't small by no rights. Joel's. I'll tell you in a minute.
Got battles in at quarterback. It's a trick play. The ball's on the ground, and we're going to fall on it, but behind the line, and we're going to have to turn it over. So we tried something, a little reverse action. It looked like we were going to do a double reverse. Never got the exchange after the snap. And it will be Chilton County ball. So the good drive breaks down on the Chilton County side on the fourth and short. And the Tigers of Chilton County will take over.
You know, that could have been an exciting play there if we handled the ball well. It looked like it might have developed into something.
Yeah,
opportunistic there.
Yeah, Brody Ellis was wide open on a post route. Oh, goodness.
Here's a run up the middle with Jackson. He is off and running, and he is going to take it all the way for a touchdown. Well, a turnover on downs, and the next play, a touchdown for Chilton County, and they have the early 6-0 lead.
And that was all hard on him because we hit him and should have tackled him with about a 3 or 4 yard gain. But you got to wrap up.
Well, you know, we've had this issue with players going off on us, and every single football game, somebody's had about 200 yards. And let's hope it's not Donald Jackson tonight, but he's starting off the right way.
Well, he didn't give up on the play. He was caught, jumped over a pile, and then took off.
Well, they say that the old line, you can't stop him, you hope to contain him. We would love to contain him and avoid some big night. Tonight, here's a kick by Castillo inside the left upright. Good. With 2 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the first quarter, it is Chilton County on top first. They lead 7-0.
Hey, are we chumming the same as usual?
Yeah.
How's your baby girl doing?
She's great, but with 3 kids, we really need more space.
You should check out Guardian Credit Union. We got a home equity line of credit from Guardian to finish our basement. They have low rates and a great team that's easy to work with.
Really?
Yeah, my mom got a Guardian home loan to buy her house. They refinanced, too.
Thanks. I'll check them out.
Connect with Guardian for all your lending needs.
Federally insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Opportunity, NMLS number 912757.
Hi, I'm Kari Sid, owner of Grove Station. We want to invite you to come in and join us for lunch, dinner, or brunch. We're open Tuesday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m., and we run dinner on Thursday and Friday nights from 5 p.m. to 8. Brunch is Saturday and Sunday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. We do private and hosted dining experiences in our loft. We're located in downtown Tallassee. We're on Facebook and Instagram. See you in a minute.
River Region Sports.
I have a feeling we'll hear something this afternoon.
Noon to two weekdays on Score 94 and Hit 106.
Donald Jackson's 56-yard run has made it a touchdown lead for Chilton County as they tack on the extra point, 7-0. And the kick will go into the end zone. It'll be Tallassee ball out at the 20-yard line. Castile on the kick. 7-0, 2:29 remaining in this first quarter of play.
Yeah, I noticed that young man had a pretty strong leg during warm-ups. He was hitting the ball pretty hard. So, you know, that's a weapon in college. I mean, in high school, because if it breaks the plane at all, they cannot return it.
That's true.
So.
Well, Tallassee deep in their own territory. They had a pretty nice drive that started back deep and inside their own 20. And got out across midfield after a couple of first downs. They were stuffed on fourth down after they fumbled the football in the backfield. So let's see what can happen here with Morris and shotgun, and McCary moving over to his right. He wants to throw.
And nice protection.
Deep, and they're going to throw down the field, and it's going to be up and through the hands of McKenzie, who was on the sideline. He could not hold on to it. I don't know if he would have come down in bounds either way. Incomplete second down.
Yeah, we had good protection on the play. Oz saw that too, and we were just within an eyelash of making a pretty good pass play right there.
Yeah, that's something that's good tonight. He hasn't had protection. Last week had pretty good protection, but he had a good pocket.
Second and 10. It is a run by McCary, hit immediately at the line, no gain. Third and 10. I like the deep shot, but now after a couple of no gains, it's third and 10.
Yeah, and it almost puts you in a passing play to where they can just pin their ears back and come after you. It's going to have to kind of be a
three receivers available here on a play-action throw, looking down the right side. Throw caught,
oh, caught
by Ellis at the sticks. He should have the first down.
That was a good catch.
Yes. Third and 10 conversion for the Tigers after the 31. That's all you have to do right there.
Yeah, that was pretty. I mean, basically Ellis ran an out route from the inside slot position, and Trent rode to this side to give him a little bit more time, and he threw it in there, and Ellis slid across the ground to catch it. That was a good play.
Nice play, yep.
Really hard to defend that play, guy.
No
really
doubt. Good play, and we needed it. McCary avoids a three and out for sure. Here's a handoff left side. Hooks tries to step outside, gets by a couple of guys, puts his shoulder pads down, and is unable to get anything. He's going to lose a yard. Out to the 30, it'll be second and 11. You know, Joseph has been playing injured, really. He and Christian McCary have been banged up. But we've had several guys who have been on this team. Those are our backs. And they've had to just play the best they can. Not probably quite 100%, but the best they've been since early in the year.
Now, Joel is back in. I'll tell you in a minute.
It's going to be a handoff on the jet sweep to McKenzie as he is taken down hard at the 33-yard line. Ran a long way to pick up about three.
Where's the horse collar on that?
Almost looked like a face mask.
Yeah, it'd be third down.
Joel, our center, he's 320. Easy. Now tell me how much their nose guard is. Oh, he just come back off the field, I think. He did. Number 66.
I looked him up. He is 6'2", 360.
I was going to say he was bigger than Joel. For sure.
He's a big fella. They got another one that's 385 standing on the sideline.
Great.
Time is called as the first quarter has expired. Chilton County 7, Tallassee nothing. Tallassee Tigers football on WTLS, Tallassee Times TV, and Spectrum.
Hi, friends. Eric Kressler here at Tallassee Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram. I invite you to join us now through October 31st for our Jeep Adventure Days. Make your best deal on the all-new 2023 Jeep Grand Cherokee, Wrangler, or Gladiator. We also have a huge selection of 2023 Dodge Chargers and 2023 Dodge Challengers on sale and ready for delivery. Shop our complete inventory online at TallasseeAutomotive.com. Tallassee Automotive, drive a little, save a lot.
Score 94 and hit 106. Rock and Jocks.
Seven nothing after a quarter. Chilton County leads as we look through the stats.
Tallassee, 4 first downs, 12 rushes for 43 yards, 2 of 3 passing for 9 yards. Look at Chilton County, 2 first downs, 5 rushes for 69 yards, 1 of 2 passing for 8 yards. Didn't really need to with that long run.
Couple of scores for you. Realtown leads 14 to nothing. Oh. Midway through the first quarter at Cleburne County.
Good job, Realtown.
Yeah, 7-0 Elmore County over St. Clair County. That's in the first quarter. Pass over the middle.
Good
nice catch by Segrist. He's out across the 50, taking down the 49. DeMarcus Riddick's like, well, this is a big fella right here. I'm going to take him down, but it's not easy.
And, you know, that's who he caught the ball against.
Yes.
Was Riddick, and he was all over Segrist. That was a beautiful throw. And a great catch by Segrist right there on that play.
And I'm going to tell you, Trent took a lick, but he stayed in there and delivered a beautiful ball.
It's something. He's just a ninth grader. He's a tough one for a little guy. He's taken some hits already this year back there, but he stands tough.
Let him grow about 4 more inches and put on about 30 pounds.
He's got plenty of room to grow.
Yes.
First and 10 Tigers midfield. So we have just started the second quarter, a 7-0 game. Chilton County leading. Morris throws again, complete to Ellis. That's the play they hit on a 3rd and 10 a moment ago. They'll pick up 10 more here for another Tallassee first down at the 40 of Chilton County.
Hey, you do that a bunch of times in a row, it's going to get your linebackers and your safeties off the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, Tallassee mixing it up. You can mix it up when you have a guy who can throw it and guys who can catch it, and we're starting to see that develop here with this offense. It will be a running play this time. Nowhere to go for McCary. He is met in the backfield. I got to say, Dante Franklin is a load, too. Number 35 for Chilton County has made a lot of plays already. Tough to get a block on him.
Yeah, he's a very active dude there along the defensive line. And he's kind of like the defensive lineman that you saw back in the 80s. Not very big, but extremely fast.
He's wreaking havoc so far. Second down, now 11 to go for the Tigers on the other side of the 40. Shotgun for Morris. Motion man is McKenzie, and it will be a quarterback sneak or draw, and he did what he could to get back close to the original line of scrimmage, and now 3rd down and a long 10.
It almost at. There for a second, it looked like he was going to have a pretty good pickup, but then that hole closed up extremely fast.
Yeah, run it a couple of times. I think they're seeing it now. He's had a couple of runs and some success early, but not that time. Big 3rd down. Like to get at least some of it back if you don't pick it up. They've been able to go to the sticks and throw to Brody Ellis a couple of times. And it will be Morris under duress. He can't quite get away as he is tackled by shoestrings at the 35. It'll bring up 4th down. Once again, that was Franklin who came in and made the open field tackle. If he doesn't make that play, then it would have been a 1st down for Trent Morris.
For sure. For sure.
4th and 6 from the 35. This is not really punting territory. 7-0 game. Chilton County in front here in the second quarter. Tallassee on its first possession got on the Chilton County side and stalled on 4th down. It was 4th and 2. This is 4th and 6. Morris from the shotgun. Oh, try to get away from the rush. He will. Looks, throws over the middle. Too high, incomplete. And that will be another turnover on downs.
Yeah, I think Trent on that one should have just kept it and ran.
I thought he had a shot to maybe run for it, yeah.
Yeah, he had some green grass in front of him, but he did have a receiver streaking wide open, and then he slipped and fell. So it's just one of those deals that was kind of bad luck because we did have the play open. I mean, he made the right read. The dude just fell down, you know. There ain't nothing you can do about that.
Chilton County back on offense with a 7-0 lead. 8:59 to go in the second quarter of play. They want to throw, and they do. Over the middle, and it's caught by Osley, and he will get out across the 45 to the 48-yard line, still on the Chilton County side. First down.
That's the guy Oz was mentioning early, number 9, Osley. That dude's big, man. He looks like he ought to be playing tight end, and he's out here playing receiver.
Yeah, he's a big old boy, big target for the quarterback.
Real Town has gone ahead 20-0. They're still in the first quarter. Big game for Real Town on the road. It's outside of the region, but a chance to kind of measure where they are, and they're really putting on a show right now against Cleburne County. A little busted play. Coppage running for it. He's just going to have to throw it down the field, and it is caught.
Oh,
it fumbled. Tallassee's got the ball at the 30, and here they come back the other way. 35. Chumley with a recovery. Hit out of bounds. It is Tallassee football. It was a great catch down the field by Moats, but then he dropped the ball. Chumley picked it up, and that's a turnover, and Tallassee will take it.
I don't know how to do caught the football. Let's just start there.
I thought he was just going to throw it away for one.
I mean, he just stuck out one hand, kind of like the highlight reel this weekend from the college. I don't forgot which team it was now, but he just kind of stuck his hand out, caught the ball, and then fumbled it, and Chumley had the vision to pick that up and pick up about 5 or 6 yards coming back this way. What a turn of events on one play.
For some reason, I think they're going to move it back. I guess you can't advance it.
Can't advance it in high school.
Chaser. All right. Well, the 38-yard line.
Chaser's
still Tallassee ball, though.
He's probably thinking, why couldn't y'all let me know that before I got beat to death over here on the sideline? But anyway, good return by Chase.
Yeah, good pickup.
Yes.
No doubt. Tallassee with the football.
It's opportunity right here.
A couple of drives where they've had success, but no points to show for it. Morris, high snap, rolling right, looking to pass. Only receiver out there is McKenzie, and he's hit behind the line of scrimmage. Yeah, well, they're going to give him the four progress. Right at the line, he's maybe got a yard. Second down.
Yeah, and that was number 5, Justin Goodwin, or Godwin. Let me see. Yeah, Godwin on that play.
Got movement. Going to be a penalty against Tallassee for a procedure or a false start, at least. Back them up, and it'll be second down and 14.
Yeah, we got a little jumpy.
Kind of changes your thinking up on second and long behind the sticks. Maybe play fake and a keeper by Morris. He will get back to the 39, close to that original line, and it will bring up third down. Picked up 5. Third and 9 is going to be the situation. Let's see if we can come up with another first down.
Yeah, I was kind of thinking when you got big number 66 in there, if you can turn him just a crease, Trent, you know, can get by him and our other running backs and get to the second level before they get hit. You can't run it straight at him. You kind of got to get him turned just a hair.
Rolling to the left, coming back, trying to run with it, and they're going to be hit behind the line. No gain, maybe even a sack based on where they tackled him. Tallassee's going to have to punt it away. Fourth down and 10.
like he gave up on the play. He started to roll out. He saw a hole, at least he thought he saw a hole, and then it closed quickly.
Here comes Battles in the punt. Well, we couldn't capitalize on the turnover by Chilton County, a three and out, our first of the night, and Chilton County will be getting the football back. Luke Motes is back to return it. Again, Mason Battles will be punting it.
Number nine's not even covered.
High snap. Better get it off quick. They got to him. A low line drive punt. It will take a good Tallassee roll inside the 30, 25, and roll down to the 20-yard line. Good job by Battles to kind of flip the field. We'll see if the defense can come up with a stop as we're midway through this second quarter, a 7-0 Chilton County advantage.
Yeah, that was a good, nice field flip by Battles there to get it back down to the 20. So they got 80 yards to go.
Remind you that at the end of the half, it will be the Parker Tire Service Center halftime report. We'll have the Pride of Tallassee band for you. Have the Student Athlete of the Week presented by District Attorney Mike Segrist and some scores. Coppage will swing it out to Jackson. A lot of room out there. He's out across the 20. Good tackle by Chumley, driving him out of bounds up at the 24-yard line. He picked up 4 yards.
Yeah, Chase did a good job of tracking him down because, like you said, he had a lot of grass on this side over here.
Second down, 6 to go. Hand off to Jackson this time. Nice cutback. He's got a first down across the 35 out to the 38. Well, a big drive right now because Tallassee's in a situation where they can't afford to go down two scores. If they can get a stop and maybe get the ball back, a chance. Maybe we can even this thing up and go to the locker room knowing we get the ball to start the second half.
Yeah, our defensive line on that play, you know, they didn't have very good gap integrity on that play.
Got 5 along the front for the Tigers with a first and 10 from the 38. And they're going to swing it out again. And there's a catch made and some room to run. And another nice first down gain out to the 48-yard line. That one to the receiver Marco Simon. And they say it is enough for another first down.
Yeah, Rush Wright and Chase Chumley was on the stop on that play. But it's one of those deals, we're not getting our hat on him until he's already picked up his first down. We got to try to hit him a little bit sooner than that.
Seems pretty basic. 4 minutes and 10 seconds remaining in the quarter. Jackson hitting the backfield, breaks a couple of tackles, and then gets to the 43. Had a chance to stop him at the line of scrimmage, and he picked up 7 yards.
Yeah, you got to wrap up.
We talked about that with Coach Mike Battles this week. He said we have struggled tackling. That's the biggest problem. We're there to make plays. We're just not wrapping them up. And there was a case in point right there. We'll see if we can get a stop here on second and short.
The same way on the long touchdown run. We hit him at the line of scrimmage.
Well, the back moved.
Jackson hit behind the line by Whittington. Nice play. And coming in to clean it up is Carter Sayers. He did not get the first down, it looks like. It looks like third down and maybe about a yard.
Yeah.
They might bring the chains out just to see, though. Nope, they just said first down.
You know, they're doing that a lot now. They don't measure. They just eyeball it.
Yeah. 3:18 left in the first half. Another first down for Chilton County, driving with a 7-0 lead. I think it's a good time to take a timeout and give our troops a rest. That's what we're going to do here. 3:11 to go in the first half of play, 7-0 Chilton County.
This is Tom Crane with Tallassee Rehab. This marks our 25th year in the Tallassee community, and this football season will be year 20 on the sidelines for our own Sterling Turner. At Tallassee Rehab, we're grateful for the relationships we've had over the past 2+ decades. Let our certified staff give you a hand with your injury. Tallassee Rehab, 1000 Friendship Road.
Hey, this is Jeremy Taunton with Tallassee True Value. Come by and see me, Dale Taylor, or Brad Roberts for all your building material needs. And if you need a paint color matched, we can do it with our state-of-the-art matching system. Tallassee True Value, we're local folks you've trusted since 1993. For all your hardware, lumber, paint, plumbing supplies, plumbing fixtures, windows, doors, nuts, and bolts, we've got it. And if we don't, we can get it for you. Tallassee True Value, 1400 Gilmer Avenue.
Stretch it out. Got him.
Score 94 and hit 106. Rock and Jocks.
I lost some yards, 11.
Right and Wells with a tackle on the running back, Ray. Is he a stop behind the line at second down and 11? 41-yard line. Now, Tallassee, 2:43 left in the first half of action. 7-0 Chilton County with the football and the lead. Coppage. Like that was movement there. Oh, yeah, definitely. They got moving before the ball was snapped. That'll back them up five more.
I was like, are they not going to call that?
Need a stop on this drive. 2:29 left in the first half of play. The penalty backs him up to the 47-yard line and makes it second down and 16. Just avoid a big play. See if we can make them stall here. Pistol formation for Coppage. Jackson there with him. They'll give it, fake it to him. Here he looks to pass. Pressure coming, and he's looking for a receiver. Just going to have to throw it away. Avoided a big sack. He had Whittington bearing down on him, third down and long.
Yeah, Whittington had him dead to rights, and their quarterback, Kopich, he knew that too, so he threw it out of bounds. But Eli was able to get to him because we had good coverage downfield. Number 11 for us, Cortland, the guy that he was really targeting, he was on him and just would not let him go like glue, you know.
Timeout is called by Chilton County, and we'll hold it here with 2:06 still to go.
Well, you know, I don't blame them for calling a timeout right here because this is actually a big third down for both teams.
No doubt.
You know what I'm saying? If we can get a stop right here and with little to no gain, it's going to put them in a punt situation. We can get the ball back. So, but if they pick up the first down, then we're in a hole and got to try to keep them out of the end zone with about a minute and a half left to go. So,
you know, I'm going to tell you, even if they get 6-8 yards, I think they're going for it.
Oh, I do too. Yeah.
Elmore County 14-0 now in St. Clair County. Stanhope leads Prattville 14-6. 21-0 Real Town over Cleburne County. Now 26, just scored again.
They land a lumber to Cleburne County, aren't they?
They really are.
I thought that'd be a pretty close ball game. They move
third
again.
Down at 16. And there is no flag, though, as the quarterback was in the grasp. And incomplete, they will not throw a flag for grounding. It'll be fourth down, and now they will punt it. 1:56 on the clock.
Good play by Christian McCary and Joseph Hooks. He didn't have nowhere to go.
Give our secondary a lot of credit for that one.
Castile will punt it, Chumley to return it. Right now, you're going to probably play safe back here. You don't want to make a mistake.
Yeah, right now, you just want to make sure you catch the football.
This guy's got a leg. He punts and kicks. And he hit that one short. So he's going to hit at the 25 and be downed at the 23 of Tallassee. That's where they'll have it with 1:46 on the clock. And I wouldn't expect a whole lot right here.
I wouldn't either, but, I mean, at this point right now, what do you have to lose?
Yeah. Well, the football game.
hey, they're actually going for it right here. Let's see what they can do.
We'll see. I just don't want to give up a play when you get the ball to start the second half when you're back on your own 20.
That's right.
23-yard line to be exact. So we'll see. Yeah, maybe we can make some noise. We got a guy that can sling it. And they are going to go with two wide on the right and another on the left side. McCary to backfield. It will be Christian who gets the handoff, and he will gain a couple to the 25-yard line. Second and 8. Clock winding down at 1:37.
Number 6 is playing extra deep safety right now. Don't want to get hit over the top for a cheap touchdown.
And as fast as he is, he can cover the field.
Yes.
Neither team using a timeout. I think Tallassee is willing to let it go down. They might try to do something if they get close to the end lap, but don't want to give a chance to Chilton County. Running play again, McCary. He's upended at the 29. It will be third down, about four, and this is where we see a timeout. Chilton County does at least want to see if they get a stop and make a punt, have something to work with for the final 58 seconds. We'll take a quick break, too. It's 7-0, Chilton County.
My name's Tristan Moon, owner of Moon's Barbecue at 563 Jordan Avenue in Tallassee, Alabama. Moon started back in Talladega, Alabama in the 50s when my granddad ran it, H.T. Moon. Now we're bringing it to Tallassee to keep the Moon's tradition going. We like to bring great barbecue. We serve everything from pulled pork ribs, brisket, chicken, mac and cheese, baked bean, potato salad, coleslaw. We do a dessert of the week. We're also actively hiring. Please come see us at 563 Jordan Avenue, Tuesday through Saturday from 11 to 7.
This is Brad Parker with Parker Tire and Service Center.
And this is Jamie Bush. We sell BF Goodrich, Michelin, Toyo, just about any tire you need. And we do services on your cars like oil changes, air conditioning, water pumps, just about any maintenance that your car needs.
We just want to thank our many customers for allowing us to serve the Tallassee area for the last 30 years and look forward to the next 30 here at Parker Tire and Service Center, 1508 Gilmer Avenue in Tallassee.
Check us out on the web at parkertire.com and follow us on Facebook.
Score 94 and hit 106.
After the timeout, Morris runs for a short game, brings up fourth down and one at the Tigers on 32, and immediately Chilton County calls another timeout. And it's their final timeout, I think, right off?
That's right.
So they got 50.9 seconds until halftime. They're going to make us punt, and they'll have that much time to work with no timeouts. That is assuming we punt the football here, which right. I expect we will on our own 32 on a fourth down.
They're going after this one.
Oh, can't blame them. Here's Battles on to do the duty. He will punt it, and they'll send Moats back to return it. Now they're going to send him off and say, Riddick, you take it. Well, they were late getting the player off. They could get a penalty. They did not. Good punt. Boy, he really boomed that one. Riddick back, makes a fair catch at his 30. Great job by Battles. That's big. And with just 43 seconds left, they've got to work most of the field now. That was a great punt.
It was. He couldn't have picked a better time to hit that.
Did you get a distance on it? I didn't happen to.
I will in just a second.
They could have hit them with a
36 yards.
Too many men on the field.
Yeah, a 36 with no return. That's the main thing. It's
that's
36
right.
net, and it was just a good-looking punt. All right, so here we go with 43.5 seconds till halftime. Chilton County, which likes to throw it, with a chance.
God, that
once
back
again,
is
I
moving
thought
every
left
time.
Early again. Here comes pressure, and they'll throw it away. It'll be second and 10. Look out for the cheerleaders.
The cheerleaders are like, wait a minute, timeout. We're not the intended receiver. We got a flag in the backfield.
Yep.
Pressure flag on number 99, Michael. Ineligible man downfield. Be a 5-yard penalty.
I think they could have called either one. I'm like, odds, that back's moving before the ball snapped.
Every time.
Yeah. At least it looks that way. Here's first and 15 now with 33.2 till halftime. They got to be careful, too, that they don't make a mistake.
Remains first down.
As Coppage gets his receivers set, and they'll run it with Jackson. Jackson right up the middle, nowhere to go. A couple of yards, and that might do it. I'm not sure if they'll try to run another play or not.
Yeah, I think we're going to go to the locker room right here, boys.
That's exactly what it looks like. Don't see a reason to try anything, and that's what they're going to do. Say, good enough, 7-0 Chilton County after a first half of action. As we get ready for the Parker Tire Service and a halftime report, the Pride of Tallassee coming up next here on WTLS Tallassee Times TV on YouTube and Spectrum.
And at WTLS, there's no shortage of football conversation. From Monday morning quarterbacking to play-by-play coverage of the Alabama Crimson Tide and the Tallassee Tigers, we've got the Lindy's Football Report and Nick Saban Show on Thursday nights, and On Location Broadcast on Fridays with the wake-up call at First Community Bank and River Region Sports live at Louie's. Regardless of the day, we're always kicking the pigskin around. WTLS, Score 94 and Kit 106.
All of us at HDD Broadband are extremely proud to offer our state-of-the-art fiber-to-the-home network. We are now offering residential packages, which consist of 250 megabytes for $65 a month, 500 megabytes for $75 a month, 1 gig for $95 a month, and 2.5 gigs for $165 a month. We've lowered our residential rates as we committed to in 2022 and have incorporated a 1 gig service and a 2.5 gig service for residential and commercial customers. Current customers may call and adjust their data packages if they wish or enjoy their new adjusted rate based on their current service. Please give us a call at 334-430-0049 to apply for service and information on our new rates. You may add us on Facebook at HDD Broadband to stay up to date on our current locations and updates on pre-registration. Feel free to view our webpage at hddbroadband.com.
The GI Lab at Community Hospital is one of the leading specialty departments in our area. The GI Lab specializes in performing diagnostic and therapeutic procedures such as colonoscopy, which is the gold standard for colon cancer detection. Colon cancer is the second leading cause of death in the United States. More than 50,000 people lose their life to this disease each year. Colon cancer does not discriminate and it affects all racial and ethnic backgrounds. Colon cancer can occur at any age, but those 50 years or older have an increased risk for developing colon cancer. At Community Hospital, the GI Lab's main goals are to increase awareness of colon cancer, encourage participation in the colon screening process, and perform these screenings with a caring and professional attitude. Schedule an appointment today with Dr. Tom Bianchi, our gastroenterologist, at 283-3862. The GI Lab at Community Hospital is here to provide our community with quality, compassionate health care.
People are talking about revived traditions. It's not football or baseball or basketball, not soccer, volleyball, or lacrosse, but it goes with any sport. It's Louie's Chicken Fingers, 1410 Gilmer Avenue in Tallassee. Louie's has chicken fingers, wings, catfish, hush puppies, fresh veggies, salads, wraps, and more. Catering is available too. Specials and updates on Facebook at Louie's of Tallassee. Before the game, after the game, anytime is Louie's time. Louie's Chicken Fingers, 1410 Gilmer Avenue, 991-4367.
Hey, it's Brad Parker
and Jamie Bush at Parker Tire and Service Center.
It's tailgating time. Don't let car troubles ruin your road trips.
Let us help you with new Michelin, Uniroyal, BF Goodrich, and Toyo tires.
Whether you're headed to the big game or just across town, change your oil, lube, and filter.
And don't forget a checkup for your engine.
Parker Tire and Service Center.
1508 Gilmer Avenue in Tallassee.
The Tallassee Chamber of Commerce invites you to Tallassee Trade Day, Saturday, October 21st at Tallassee City Hall. Vendors, food, entertainment, children's activities, and contests are all part of the Trade Day activities. Contests include a karaoke contest, a moon pie eating contest, and a costume contest for children ages 5 to 14. The Decorated Pumpkin Contest is for all ages. Contest winners receive cash prizes. The children's area will have a bouncy house, rock climbing wall, and a hayride. Tallassee Trade Day, Saturday, October 21st, 8 to 1 at Tallassee City Hall. Don't worry, chillax. With Chillax Comfort Heating and Air, no matter the season, no matter the job, installs on new construction, service calls, or changeouts, contact Mac at Chillax. That's Mac Smith, with 27 years in the business, and he's always on call. 24/7. Call 415-1188. Look him up on Facebook and be sure to like Chillax Comfort Heating and Air. Alabama license number 23205.
WTLS Tallassee Pike Road. The home for the Tallassee Tigers since 1954. Score 94 and hit 106.
It's intermission. That means it's time for the Parker Tire and Service Center Halftime Report.
And welcome back. This is the Parker Tire and Service Center Halftime Report. Stephen Oz Osborne here with Brad Davis. Brad, I'm going to go ahead and hit some stats real quick. We'll go into some analysis. Tallassee, first downs, 5 first downs. Rushes, 19 for 57 yards. 5 of 7 passing for 16 yards. Hold on a minute. Something's not looking right about that. I got to look at these stats again. Oh, I know what happened. There was an issue with one of them. But we'll get that resolved. This new program I've got has messed me up a little bit. Chilton County, first down, 6. Rushes, 10 for 87 yards. They're 5 of 8 on completions for 53 yards. They've done most of their damage on the ground. And that was that one run. Oh, I'm going to be honest with you. Tallassee has played really well this first half for being the smaller team.
Sure.
And
what did they have? Was it a 60-yard run?
It was a 56-yard run.
Okay, so that puts him just over 20, 25-ish type yards on the ground, right, with the total?
Rush, 87 total.
Okay, so you take 56 from that, we're so, right at 30 yards. You know, it's a situation where, you know, I think going into this game, the things that Tallassee has done today or tonight are probably – exactly the things that you have to do to think you're going to be able to be in the ball game. And so they've moved the ball. They've been able to convert on some passes, picked up a couple first downs on that. You know, we talked about it. You guys talked about it on air. And it's on the sideline. You can hear the coaches talking amongst themselves. The pass is really, really hard to defend when you run a guy out there. And he breaks, you know, he's throwing the ball before the receiver breaks to the point where he's throwing at the sticks. And it's really hard to defend. And I think Ellis has made that catch once on our sideline. I'm not sure who made the other catch. It may have been Ellis again. But, you know, they're going there catching that low ball, and Trent's able to get it out there. We've done some things on the ground. I think they adjusted. But the speed sweep, which is, you know, it's something new that we saw pop up here in the last couple of weeks with Chumley running that. He really plants his foot and gets upfield. And him doing that has opened up a new weapon on offense. And so we haven't really – taking that deep shot yet. I think we did try to throw it deep once, but I think it was out of just trying to get the ball out of Trent's hand versus really having a play set. You know, last week we had the guy in the seam a couple of times. I think they've seen that on film and they're ready for that. You guys mentioned Riddick's playing off the ball now in that safety position versus a linebacker because he's trying to play there to defend that. So we'll see what they do differently, and then we'll see what we do. Look, I think the coaches have to be pleased and the players have to feel really good about the way the first half's gone for the Tigers, the Tallassee Tigers, it is.
Yeah, they make some adjustments. I don't know. We got to get off the field on third down for one because they are extending some of their drives. But, you know, we were opening up some holes early. Kind of seemed like we either – got away with that or they made their adjustments and we're closing those holes. Hopefully we can find something to get some positive yardage. We know we're not throwing to the side that Riddick's on. Every
sure.
pass has been away from Riddick, and we know why, because he's a 4-star.
But you guys talked about his size, I think, there in the first quarter. So 6'3", 230-ish, something like that. I don't know what he's listed at, but along with that size, he's really quick. So he covers that half of the field, you know, and he covers it really well. So I just think, I mean, if you play, you know, if it's us or anybody else, you're probably really not doing yourself a justice to throw the ball in that direction, especially when you have other options. And so we've got a couple of guys that have made some plays this year. I think, you know, I really do think we're going to go back to that receiver on the hashes and that slot receiver McKenzie was last week. We'll see what we got this week.
Quick outs.
Yeah.
Yep. This has been the Parker Tire and Service Center Halftime Report. We'll be right back with the pride of Tallassee.
The wake-up call.
There's another thing I came up with as I drove across the bridge. Mount Dumpmore in Tallassee.
They're going to dump on us.
Man, we're dumping there. It's a landfill.
It's gradually getting hot.
They're dumping right in their backyard. They don't have to dump on top of somebody.
Wake up with the Wake Up Call. Weekdays at 6 on Score 94 and Hit 106. Streamed live on Facebook and 1300WTLS.com.
At CBNS Bank,
We're always at the forefront of providing tailored, cutting-edge financial solutions to our customers. It's just another reason why CBNS Bank has been here since 1906. Meet your financial goals with our customer-focused checking accounts and savings accounts for all of life's stages, events, and seasons. Compare our accounts online for the custom features that keep you moving forward at cbsbank.com. CBNS Bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Are you in the market for a new home, selling yours, or would like to rent? Let Newstone Realty help you. We serve the Tri-County area, offering both sales and property management services. Visit our website for information on featured properties at newstonehomes.com. Newstone Realty, LLC, a member of the National Association of Realtors, Equal Housing Opportunity.
Score 94 and hit 106.
Brian, it's Adelsey performing at halftime. The Parker Tire and Service Center halftime report. Chilton County leading 7-0. Thank you. Pride of Tallassee performing at halftime again. The score, Chilton County 7, Tallassee nothing.
Hey, this is Jeremy Taunton with Tallassee True Value. Come by and see me, Dale Taylor, or Brad Roberts for all your building material needs. And if you need a paint color matched, we can do it with our state-of-the-art matching system. Tallassee True Value, we're local folks you've trusted since 1993. For all your hardware, lumber, paint, plumbing supplies, plumbing fixtures, windows, doors, nuts and bolts, we've got it. And if we don't, we can get it for you. Tallassee True Value, 1400 Gilmer Avenue.
Hi friends, it's Eric Cresswell here for Tallassee Ford Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram. We are proud to support Tallassee Tigers football. On behalf of our entire staff, we would like to thank all of our coaches and trainers for your time and the positive impact you have on our kids. Football teaches many life lessons like teamwork, discipline, respect, and both physical and mental health. When you're ready to purchase your next vehicle, please come by and let our hometown team help you. Shop our complete inventory at TallasseeAutomotive.com. Go Tigers!
Score 94 and hit 106.
Time for our Segrist Law Student Athlete of the Week. It is sponsored by District Attorney Mike Segrist. And this week's featured athlete, student athlete that is, Brody Ellis, the son of Jeffrey Ellis and Jana Ellis. Wears number 6 for the Tigers, plays wide receiver and cornerback. His fourth year playing with the Varsity Tigers. He has played football for about a decade. He also plays basketball and plays different positions on the court. He'll be in his second year with the Varsity this year as he played basketball for the past 8 years. Brody's unsure of his future plans after graduation, but is thinking maybe college or the military. He's taken honors, AP, and dual enrollment classes while at THS. Brody has maintained a numerical GPA of 83, which is a 2.74. His dream job is to be an ESPN sports reporter. His nickname is Fody, which he got from his cousin Channing Ellis. Brody's favorite food is pepperoni pizza. His favorite color, blue. And not having to walk to classes in the rain is his favorite thing about the new high school. The advice he gives upcoming football players is to keep working, keep trying, and don't give up. Again, your student athlete of the week is Brody Ellis, again, sponsored by District Attorney Mike Segrist. And we move along to give you some scores. We've got several games. Most of them are at halftime right now. One blowout going on with Real Town. They're up 42-0, and that's still is a first-half score, a wild
saw that one coming,
route going on. I did not. I really didn't think that was going to happen. Just got a report that about a minute left in the first half, and they're on the road. I don't know how many teams have come into Claiborne County. I know they're not where they used to be, but route
still
them like they're doing, 42-0. That's just wild.
Strong.
Elmore County, last check, was 14-0. That was a second-quarter score, leading St. Clair County homecoming and eclectic. Also, some other scores. Charles Henderson is up on St. James. That game in Montgomery tonight, 15-0 is the score there. Some other scores from games being played in our neck of the woods include a matchup that's happening in Prattville tonight with Stanhope Elmore in the Lions of Prattville, and it is Stanhope winning on the road, 14-6. That's a second-quarter score. We have Alabama Christian leading Montgomery Academy. That game at MA, it's 7-0 ACA. Lanier on the road at Jasper tonight, in front of Jasper by a score of 13-10. Ramsey against Auburn playing, and this is a big matchup with two big teams. We had one last night with different classifications being represented, and Clay Chalkful and Thompson on national television with ESPNU. This is similar. This is a 5A versus a 7A. That was a 6A, 7A versus the top dog. And Ramsey leads. It's 7-3 at halftime. So you know how good Ramsey is. They won a state championship last year. And we know how good Auburn is, obviously. Trinity leads Marbury 14-6. And it is 7-6. Opelika leading Theodore. Now 10-6. They've gone to halftime. Those are some of the scores we have. We'll follow those games throughout the second half. We have the scoreboard show to follow. Course right here on WTLS, and we'll have that followed by the Lindy's football report, and as we see it tonight until midnight. We're busy with football. Alabama tomorrow following the Tallassee football replay. Of course, it's a late start. Alabama's at Mississippi State, an 8 o'clock kick, 5 o'clock airtime. Toby, hope you're doing well.
Yes.
Toby Ward messaging us. You know, he's had some heart issues. He's been checked out. And we're thinking about you, Toby. Toby, of course, helps us out with the Spectrum feed on our simulcast for the audio on Spectrum Channel 340. And been doing that for a long time. And I know you'll have a speedy recovery. He's watching tonight.
And you know, and I know he hates not being here. He's got a daughter that's in the band. It's a majorette. Everything, and like you say, Toby's been a good friend of ours for a long, long time. Grew up with him, going to school, and certainly praying for his to get better, and wishing him well, and pray that his procedure today went well.
Second half kickoff coming up next. This has been the Parker Tire and Service Center Halftime Report.
What a combination. When it's football and May Pops Barbecue, you know you've got a winner. When you're planning for the game, be sure to mix in some May Pops. Pre-order at maypopsbarbecue.com. Pick up at their East Tallassee location on Notasoga Road or at their food truck. See the schedule by following May Pops on Facebook. May Pops, wood-fired barbecue, the fan favorite.
Instant news, immediate availability. It's here at your fingertips. TallasseeTimes.com. Read it online. Follow it on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Stay up to date on all Tallassee news, sports, socials, classifieds, and photos. Plus, get live video on all social platforms and Tallassee Times TV on YouTube. Tallassee Times. TallasseeTimes.com.
Score 94 and hit 106.
Castile has the whistle. We're ready to start the second half. Chilton County kicking off to Tallassee, leading 7-0. He kicks it high and deep. It'll be Roberts inside his 10, takes it across the 15 to the 20. Middle of the field, 25, cuts back. He's going to be wrapped up at the 26, and he will be driven down at the 28. It was hard to bring him down.
That's a good hard run by Cortland Roberts.
First down. Tigers from their own 28-yard line.
First down 10 for Tallassee at the 29.
Well, let's see if we can drive it right down the field and tie this thing up. How about it?
That'd be good. I'd like to see it.
We've moved the football. We just can't seem to finish. Trent wants to swing it out of the backfield, does to Hooks. Cuts back. He's going to be taken down for a loss. And it will be a couple of lost yards on that one, back to the 25. Second down at 12.
Yeah, just did not have any room running to the wide side of the field. Trying to, you know, stretch the play out. And Chilton County did a good job of not allowing him to cut up field.
Yeah, didn't clear anybody out either.
No.
Everybody stayed at home.
Trips formation left side. One receiver to the right. They'll swing it to the right side. It is going to be Chumley who will get to the 30. And that's pretty close to where the original line was. He might have gotten an extra yard beyond it, and it will be third and long. Third and nine, to be exact.
Yeah, nice, easy little route, though. Nothing fancy or anything.
Well, now we got to go beyond the sticks.
Yes. To
keep this drive going. It's going to take more than these swing passes. Let's see if we can go find the marker and get there. Roll out right. Morris looking down the field for Battles, and he's got it. What a throw, and what a catch
by Mason Battles.
At the 37, you couldn't have thrown it any better, and he was covered up pretty good. And Battles had the concentration to watch it right in. A great third and long conversion by the Tigers.
That was beautiful. Battles went from playing a lot of quarterback to wide receiver. And, hey, that was beautiful right there on him and Trent's part.
Made a couple of really nice catches last week.
Nice 31-yarder there.
He'll line up out on the left side this time on a first and 10 now in Chilton County territory. It will be McCary, and he is just leveled at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. Second down.
1 yard gain, second down, nine.
Yeah. Barely picked up a yard, I think, Michael. The hole closed up extremely fast on that run.
McKenzie in battles out left. Ellis to the right, shotgun for Morris. And it is Hooks hit behind the line again. We'll lose this time. And it will be third down. Maybe 11. I'm going to say 10. Looks closer to the line of scrimmage than we had. Well, no sweat. We had a third and long a minute ago and just hit one down the field. Let's see what they come up with here.
Yeah, we got to do a better job of opening up some holes and some running lanes. Right now, number 33 is very active on the defensive line.
That's Andre Underwood. He's lining up right over the football. Let's see what happens on third and about 10 for the Tigers. Morris straight back, looking to throw. Pressure coming. He's rolling right, being pressured. Throws one up for grabs. It is batted in the air, almost caught. Boy, they almost had an interception, then almost a catch for Ellis, who was double covered, but it falls incomplete. And now fourth down. This is a go-for-it down, really, because don't see us punting here on the 36-yard line.
Yeah, I don't either.
Would have been nice to get a little closer there, but we went for all the marbles. Just missed it.
Yeah, I guess we are going to punt.
Going to try to play field position, see if we can pin them back deep. And watch out. They might have a trick play up their sleeve.
Number 12, Mason Battles, in confirmation fatality.
And interesting that they have Moat standing back at his five. Usually they don't let a guy go back that far. He's going to angle it towards the sideline, try to pin him in the corner. Rolls down and rolls into the end zone. So net's only 16. And if it had been fourth and short, I think we would have gone for it. But anyway, we punted away. We're going to play defense now, see if we can get a stop, get the ball back with good field position. Tough break again. Once again, it's been the story of the night. Tallassee with some success moving the football, but unable to cash it in. Still down 7-0 with 8:30 to go in the third quarter.
We just need some consistency. You know, like I said, we hit some good plays, and then we're not consistently moving the ball. We have too many negative plays going on. They moved again.
Different formation. Jackson got it, broke a tackle out across the 30, first down run for another first down. He's out to the 32, picked up 12. First and 10, Chilton County. They're lining up with a power formation.
Oh,
there's another run with Jackson. He broke a free, and he's off and running. And a shoestring grab, thank goodness, by McKenzie. The ball came out late. I don't know if they say it was a fumble or not. We're going to see. Saying the ball was down, says this back official.
Their whole left side moved before the snap.
Yeah, I think it's more the coincidence that we see movement before the ball gets there. It looks like they're early every time. I'd like to go back and look at it a little closer, but it's definitely seems to be a little bit quick. Here's a running play, right side. They're trying to bounce it outside. Good tackle by Chumley coming up to make the play at the 25.
And that's Riddick running the ball, too, number six.
Yeah, they haven't used him much on offense this season, but they're going to give it a try here. Second and five at the Tallassee 25. He's back there again.
They move.
They do it every time. Run with DeRiddick again, left side to the 21, close to a first down.
Now they're going
to
throw a flag on us. Come on.
There's a flag on the play. Stop made the four Christian McKinney.
Personal foul against Tallassee. Well, we have got to stop doing that, though. We have had a real problem with that. Last week had a number of the 15-yard variety penalties. It'll be taken half the distance down to about the 11-yard line, and it'll be first down.
First down 10.
They do have a new running back in, and they just about didn't get that off. And Hooks is going to come in and make the play. There's a whistle. Like it whistled it before it was done, and maybe a penalty on the offense, maybe some type of false start. We'll see. I don't see any flags, though.
I have zero.
He blew that before the play was done.
Did he kneel?
Yeah, well, he moved it back to the 16, second down play. A busted play, now just going to throw it away. That's got to be grounded. There's nobody anywhere near the receivers or nowhere near. No penalty. Third down.
You got to be kidding me. He wasn't outside the pocket either. He was not outside the tackles when he threw that ball. Good golly. Miss Molly.
They are in field goal range, though. Third down play coming up here. 16-yard line, 15 for a first down. Pressure coming to the end zone. Owsley is there. He is going to make the grab. It is going to be a catch for a score. Touchdown, Chilton County. 16-yard pass from Coppedge to Owsley, and it is 13-0. Chilton County on top.
Tight end just slipped out and hit him right over the top.
Extra point by Castillo.
Number 13, Jorge Castillo, the 10th point.
Hey, you can't get fined for criticizing the officials, right?
Kick up, kick good. 14-0, 6:39 to go in this third quarter of play. Chilton County on top.
Rub-a-dub-dub. Time to give the snub to that ugly tub. Time to contact Bath Innovations. With more than 30 years of providing families in the River Region with the very best bathroom remodels. Bath Innovations ADA specialists offer tub-to-shower conversions, walk-in tubs, grab bars, and bench seats, all backed by the Good Housekeeping Seal of Approval. View their design center on the Eastern Boulevard in Montgomery, or look them up at bathinnovations.com. It's time to make your bathroom beautiful and safe with Bath Innovations of Alabama.
Blinky.
1-1-1.
Score 94 and hit 106. Rock and Jocks.
Returned by Roberts up the middle of the field. He'll cross the 20. He'll get to the 25. 14-0 now, two-score game. Chilton County leads it. And we've had 6:29 to go in this third quarter of play. Tallassee drove it down the field. Had a big play that set him up in Chilton County territory. But once again, cannot come up with the points. Decided on a fourth down and 10 to try to play field position, punted. And it wasn't long that Tigers of Chilton County found the end zone. 16-yard scoring pass has made it 14-0. Here's Tallassee, needs some offense. Rolling out, looking to pass is Mars. Pressure coming from the backside. Needs some help. He's going to have to just throw it away. Incomplete. Now, that could have been called the same thing, I guess. It was out of the box, but since we don't call that penalty, I guess, for grounding.
Well, see, previously when their quarterback threw it away, it didn't even get past the line of scrimmage. And do they do that in high school? Because
yeah, the rules are a little different in high school. I don't – I guess a judgment call by this official. But, I mean, I haven't seen – I thought tonight we've seen a couple of plays that could have been called intentional grounding, but we haven't seen it.
There's no doubt.
McKenzie in motion. We'll get the handoff going right. And nowhere to go. He is stopped for a loss in a play. It is going to be third down and long.
Yeah, we're not creating any holes.
Yeah, I don't know if there was an effort in the decision of running a lot of jet sweeps to try to tire down some of the defensive players here. But, you know, we haven't been able to seem to get much going with that. They have been quick to the corners to cut that off. course, we tried to run up the middle, too. They're pretty good defensively. That's pretty obvious. Held Kalir to just three last week. Now third down and long for the Tigers. Morris with four receivers, two on each side. Pressure coming. He's going to air it out, go down the field for Ellis, and the pass is out of bounds, incomplete. We'll have to punt it away. Three and out's not what we needed there.
No.
Yeah, you got to put the defense right back on the field. And the thing about it, most of the guys who play defense are playing on offense too.
Right.
They're getting tired.
And that's what's, you know, been happening to us a lot in the second half.
Punt. It's at midfield, rolls out of bounds at the 47-yard line of Chilton County. They'll take over there with a 14-0 lead. 5:04 left in this third quarter. Well, maybe a turnover or something. We have one turnover we got tonight, but couldn't do anything after we got it. See if we can make something happen here. I'd like to get something to get some points and get it back to a one-score game. They've gone to this kind of power eye set out of a pistol. They're going to look to throw down the field deep. And the pass is incomplete. Little contact.
Are you kidding me?
Incomplete. Penalty flag comes out. Going to be a pass interference probably on Tallassee.
We have a right to go for the ball, too.
Pass interference against Tallassee. It'll be assessed 15 yards.
I thought we had pretty good coverage.
Now in Tallassee territory, down to the 38. 15-yard step off for pass interference. Jackson on the handoff. Steps outside, good, quick move, and now he's off to the races. Inside the 20, the 10, and into the end zone for a touchdown. It's a 20-0 Chilton County lead. We've seen this before. It's starting to get away from us a little bit.
Yeah, you can tell that they're a little bit fresher than we are, especially along the lines.
Kick coming up. Castillo will put one up and put one through the uprights to make it 21-0 Chilton County. 4:39 left in this third quarter of play. Tallassee Tigers football on WTLS. Score 94 and hit 106.
This is your local State Farm agent combines good neighbor service with surprisingly great rates. You can combine your home and auto. And guess what you'll get? That's right, good neighbor service with surprisingly great rates. This is Logan Steers, your State Farm agent right here in Tallassee, to provide service at a price you want. So try combining home and auto today. Our office will help you mix and match things perfectly. Call 991-4476 or drop by our new location at 1409 Gilmer Avenue for a quote today.
Neptune.
Hi, my name is Connie Rivers. I've been at Neptune for 35 years. One of the most important things here at Neptune is safety, and we win our day by being safe. Come join us, and you can be a winner, too.
Neptune Technology Group, Tallassee, Alabama.
Score 94. And hit 106.
There it goes.
21-0. 4:39 to go. Third quarter, Chilton County leading Tallassee here from J.E. Hot O'Brien Stadium. Next week, homecoming. We'll have all the activities. A busy week ahead. Tallassee with a lot of work to do here in this one before we get there. They're down by three touchdowns now after a 7-0 halftime deficit. 21-0. It's going to be Roberts again across the 15 to 20. To the 25-yard line, and there's where Tallassee will begin.
11,
on offense, there's time left. We just got to get something going here. No offense here in the second half. We had some offense in the first. And really started the second half drive pretty good. But once again, we've stopped ourselves in Chilton County territory without being able to make the plays when we need them. And Chilton County's got a lot to do with it. They got some players out there.
Yeah. Got some really nice size players.
And they got one. They got everybody up in the box and one safety. It'd be nice to hit something over the middle.
Yeah, quick slants or something.
Fumble as the ball comes out after Morris was leveled in the backfield, and he's down, and he might be hurt. He was hit pretty hard from his backside, and the officials have called a timeout. We'll take a break, 2:49 to go, third quarter. Chilton County up 21-0.
If you're involved in an auto accident, City Collision can help. Contact Dana Haynes. Dana has 3 decades of experience with paint and body work. From minor fender benders to major repairs, see Dana for a lifetime warranty on all repairs. Insurance claims welcome. And City Collision offers truck accessories. Located on the Tallassee Highway, just past the Y, City Collision.
This is Clint McBroom from First Methodist in Tallassee. We would like to invite the children and families of our community to our Fall Festival on Sunday, October 29th from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. We'll have music, games, and free food. The church is located across the street from Tallassee High School. Again, join us for our Fall Festival on Sunday, October 29th from 4 p.m. until 6 p.m.
Keep up with the latest. Like and follow WTLS and Tallassee Times on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram.
Morris comes off the field. Tallassee goes to the Wildcat, runs Joseph Hook's right side. And he is able to get a couple, but it's still third down and long. Play in. Morris is going to come back into the game here. He was shaken up a little bit, but he's back out there on third down and about 18 to go from Tallassee's own 16-yard line. Just going to throw it down the field, intended for Ellis, and it is going to be intercepted. And bringing it back is Godwin, right side across the 40. He's to the 30-yard line, to the 20, to the 10, and he will be taken down in about the 1.
We got a flag on the field.
We got guys going at it. We got to keep our composure. And it's going back and forth. Not sure who's going to get the penalty, if it'll be offsetting, but there's definitely some extracurricular activity going on out there. Officials are talking us over, getting names and numbers right now.
Yes.
Writing it down in the notebook.
It's a whole lot of laundry on the field.
Both teams might be losing some players on this exchange here.
Yeah, we saw a lot of back and forth. It was not just isolated to a couple of guys.
Oh, no. There was plenty to go around.
Realtown up 48-0.
Good gracious.
In the third quarter over Cleburne County.
Hey, where did they rule him out?
Like a 2-1.
I'm not sure. One, maybe the two.
Okay.
And a lot where it's going to be is going to be determined on what this call is here.
I think this flag back here is going to be like a block in the back.
Yeah, didn't think about that possibility. That is the first indication against Chilton County. Then personal foul against Tallassee. Personal foul against Tallassee. Two against Tallassee. We did that last week. We had three in a row last week.
So there was zero against them?
No, one. Just one a block in the back. Yeah, but two personal foul penalties.
Personal foul down.
No, none. No, we had that happen last week. We had three called on us and 45 yards of penalties on a kickoff. And none against Marbury last week, and now two against Tattlesee on this, and none against Chilton County.
I understand the personal fouls against us, but how did they not have any either?
Well, I thought that last week, but this is back-to-back weeks. I don't know if I'm going to call both officiating crews one-sided.
That was terrible.
What?
That was terrible that they didn't call one against them.
Did you see something?
Yeah, I seen one of their guys, really hit one of our guys over here.
Well, if somebody hit somebody, they should be kicked out of the game.
I don't know that they swung, but they, shoved them, you know. So there was plenty of back and forth going on. It wasn't one-sided.
It will be marked at the 10. It's kind of weird how that worked out because they would have been at the 1 or 2. We had two penalties against us, but theirs was a spot foul, and then we step off the half the distance. It actually worked in our favor. Not to have the penalties, but the fact that it's this far down the field. And where the penalty occurred on a spot foul for the block in the back. Coach Mike Bowles is discussing it with the white hat. Maybe he's asking why there was only personal foul penalties on Tallassee.
I would too. Because, I seen their guy shoving us too, just like we were shoving them.
You saw it?
Yes, for sure.
2:24 left in the third quarter. A turnover on an interception and return gives Chilton County the football at Tallassee's 10-yard line. They have moved the chains off the field, so it will be first down and goal. Chilton County up 21-0. And looking for more. Wide open. Once again, touchdown. Kent Ousley again, and it is 27-0. Hit him with a pass to the big tight end, and nobody there to see it.
I said earlier in the game we're just going to have to watch him because he's got good hands. That's two touchdown passes to him.
I'm fixing to lose a lot of respect for this officiating crew because they just let those guys in there dance and everything. And, look, you can't do that junk in high school.
Extra point attempt by Castillo will be forthcoming. Got the snap and the hold.
Were they still moving at the snap?
It's good. 28-0, 2:08 to go, third quarter. Tallassee Tigers football on WTLS, score 94 and hit 106.
Guardian Credit Union story.
So what are we doing with your hair today?
I need a trim, a new dishwasher, and a much-needed vacation. Do you see any grays?
Sounds like you need a personal loan. My friend just got a loan from Guardian Credit Union, and he used it to upgrade his kitchen appliances.
That's what I need to do.
Guardian has great rates and a friendly team that makes payments affordable.
Perfect. I guess stylists really can fix everything.
Connect with Guardian for all your lending needs.
Federally insured by NCUA. Equal housing opportunity. NMLS number 912757.
Tallassee's leading florist is Godwin's Flowers, in the same location since 1971 in the East Tallassee Shopping Center. Godwin's Flowers are always fresh and always the highest quality for any occasion, delivering to most of the surrounding area, open from 8 to 4 weekdays, except Wednesdays, and from 8 to 11 on Saturdays. Godwin's Flowers, flowers with a personal touch in the East Tallassee Shopping Center.
Score 94 and hit 106.
Kick will sail into the end zone, but a flag at the line will make them re-kick it again.
They actually finally called an offsides against
them. I was just thinking that.
That's on, I guess, one out of 20 ain't bad.
Oh, man.
instead of 2 out of 3 by Meatloaf, 1 out of 20.
He's got the leg to kick it in the end zone again.
Yeah, dude's got a strong leg.
Yeah.
And he ain't a very big guy.
Doesn't look like he's got very long legs, but he's got some pop in him, doesn't he?
He does, indeed.
Castillo will now put it on the 35.
On the other side.
Maybe we can rip off for a turn. 28-0. 2:03 left in the third quarter. Chance for McKenzie this time. He will take it at the 15. To the 20-yard line he goes. 25. Cuts back. Cross the 30. To the 35. 36-yard line. Pretty nice return, and that's where Tallassee will take it. First down.
I think we got a young man on Chilton County down.
We do. We'll take a break. It's 1:47 to go in this, the third quarter, 28-0. Chilton County in front.
Hi, this is Brad Mason, City President of First Community Bank of Central Alabama. I would like to take this opportunity to invite each of you to stop by and visit us at one of our two convenient locations in the Tallassee community. We are located at 526 Gilmer Avenue and at 28 Neptune Road. Our friendly staff will be happy to help you with any of your financial needs. We have a wide variety of deposit products such as checking, savings, money market, and CDs. If you're wanting to buy a boat or automobile or thinking of refinancing your home, come see one of our loan officers, and we'll be glad to assist you. First Community Bank has been serving the Tallassee community for over 7 years. We are your locally owned hometown community bank. Please call us at 283-2299 or visit us on the web at fcbca.com.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Score 94 and hit 106.
First down play, Christian McCary for 3 to the 39-yard line, second at 7 Tigers. 1:26 left in the third quarter. 28-0, Chilton County in front. Well, Tigers trying to get something going here in the second half. It's gone south in a hurry.
It's certainly a tale of two halves, for sure.
Running play right side, but Hooks puts his head down, breaks a tackle. First down yardage across the 50, finally. Something good. It goes our way to the 46 of Chilton County. That's a first down.
Uh-oh, I think he's cramping.
Looks that way. Already had a player down for Chilton County for the same thing. He doesn't want to come off the field, but he's probably going to have to. This game looks a lot like the Beauregard game. You know, we had life early. We were actually up in that game 14-0 early, 14-7 and a half, and then we ended up surrendering 35 straight. Just lost gas is basically what happened. Ran out of gas in that game. Trent trying to get her loose, not going to happen. He was wrapped up in the backfield by Ricardo Parker and just couldn't break through. It'll be a sack back to about the 50 where they gave him forward progress to end this, the third quarter. 28-0, Chilton County leading. 12 minutes of football remain. Tallassee Tigers football on WTLS, Tallassee Times TV on YouTube, and Spectrum.
It's not football or baseball or basketball, not soccer, volleyball, or lacrosse, but it goes with any sport. It's Louie's Chicken Fingers, 1410 Gilmer Avenue in Tallassee. Louie's has chicken fingers, wings, catfish, hush puppies, fresh veggies, salads, wraps, and more. Catering is available, too. Specials and updates on Facebook at Louie's of Tallassee. Before the game, after the game, anytime is Louie's time. Louie's Chicken Fingers, 1410 Gilmer Avenue, 991-4367. Let's go!
Hello, this is Albert Elmore, your local State Farm agent. Guess what? We're in a new, bigger Tallassee location. Same great company, same licensed staff and agent. Contact us at 1311 Gilmer Avenue, next to Dairy Queen. Come by for a free quote, insurance review, or just call us at our same number, 283-2758.
They need to put a nice
score, 94. And hit 106.
through three quarters, 28-0. Chilton County stats through the first three.
Tallassee, first down, 7 rushes, 27 rushes for 63 yards. Passing yards are 70 yards on 8 of 14. We're going Chilton County, 12 first downs, 16 rushes for 182 yards, 79 yards on 7 of 12 passing.
All right, first play of the fourth quarter is a run by Christian McCary, which fails to gain, and we've got third down. Third down, well, I gained a couple because we were behind the sticks a little bit. Third down and 11. Ball at the 47 of Chilton County. Carver 14-0 lead over Percy Julian. That game is a halftime score.
Percy Julian is lead, right?
Orange Julius.
They're down. Oh, yeah, right. Yeah, that's right. They're losing, though. Trent throws. Hit. That one got there pretty quick. I don't know if Brody was ready for that one. Off his shoulder pads, incomplete. Boy, it just shows the zip that Trent puts on the football. Really can hum it in there. Incomplete and fourth down. We're going to punt.
Yeah, that got there pretty quick.
You got to grab it. I know Brody would have normally caught that. He's pretty sure-handed usually, but incomplete. We will have to punt it away. Here's Battles. Moats back to return. High punt. Fair catch called for and made at the 15 by Moats. Yard punt. Next week is homecoming. We brought that up a couple of times, but we'll be here for Elmore County. Tallassee's got a little streak against the Panthers, 7 straight in the series. Elmore County going to come in here with a 4-1 record. And unless things change, we're going to be 1-5. But remember last year we were 2-4 and Tallassee didn't win the game in that collective.
In a barn burner.
It was a dandy. Running play right side. Jackson's out in the open field again. Makes a nice cutback. Penalty flags come in as he got out to the 30 and out of bounds. But the first down carry should be negated by the penalty, which we're going to see here in just a minute. Two flags did come in.
Oh, he pretty much, number 9, Owsley tackled our guy. I mean,
holding is the call.
Ridiculous.
10:31 left in the football game. 28-0 Chilton County. It was a 7-0 halftime score. 50 points last week, but a goose egg tonight so far, at least. Backs them up to about the 11. Half the distance, first down and 16. Moats going way wide to the left in motion. It will be a running play, though, to Jackson right side, and he will be down around the 18, 19-yard line. Driven out of bounds right there.
Yeah, if I'm Chilton County, I'm going to try to keep this ball on the ground and keep it in bounds and try to eat clock right here.
Yeah, no reason not to.
Well, you know, couple reasons. Well, they're up 28-0, number one, and you want to try to shorten this fourth quarter as much as possible to keep from getting any of your key guys injured.
Little pitch to the receiver coming on a jet sweep, and he will get across the 20 to the 24. That was Laster on the running play. Penalty flag on that one as well.
So now they're going to call all the penalties when the game's out of reach.
Holding again, I think, was what he said.
Yeah.
And that'll back them up some more.
I think this is a lot of your backup line right here for Chilton County, and maybe that's why we're getting a few holding calls. Now, some of their speed guys and everything are still on the field. But some of the line looks like might be the second string.
Backs him up. It's second and 15. Up the middle, Jackson. out in the open field. First down yardage. Yes, he got it. And then some out across the 40 to the 42 on a second and 15. A big burst up the middle of the defense by Jackson, who's having a big night. Gives Chilton County yet another first down. We played a lot of plays, a lot of those guys out there right now.
Donald Jackson's got 213 yards right now.
And we have had another guy have a big night against us. It's one of those things that just can't seem to change for us. Lassiter again on the sweep, and a great play by McCary, taking him down as he's running around back there in the backfield. You got to get up the field.
Yep.
Or you're going to get stuffed, and he did back in the backfield for about a six-yard loss. Great play by McCary.
Yeah, he tried to reverse field on that, and Christian McCary was not having any of it.
Second down.
That's actually considered a forward pass, right?
It is, yeah. It'll be a passing play and loss on the pass. Pitched it in front of him.
Sorry, I'm laughing at the song they're playing right now.
Yeah, you just bobbing your head with it. Right side run.
Oh, yeah.
Coppage broke a tackle. Keeps his feet moving. He's driven down at the 42. Back near where the original line was. Third down coming up.
Yeah, and he made sure he slid before he got out of bounds. So he's been instructed to keep the clock running by his coach.
Charles Henderson leading St. James 29-7. Second half score.
What about that Montgomery Academy and Alabama Christian?
I don't know. I hadn't seen one lately. I have to go back and check.
Yeah, I hadn't heard you mention that one lately.
Which one?
Montgomery Academy and Alabama Christian.
Master right side run. He is hit the backfield, and they get him down. Loss on the play, third down, and nine play goes behind the sticks to fourth and 11. They'll have to punt.
Yeah, good job by Joseph Hooks on that play, making a tackle. Uh-oh.
There's a flag on the play.
Got these late flags coming in again.
Got two more of them.
Catholic leads Demopolis. It's 28-0 in that game. Realtown has added another score, 55-3. ACA 28-14 lead over Montgomery Academy. There's your answer. Appreciate the score reports coming in. .623 left in this one.
Now let's see what kind of penalties we got going on here.
Sportsmanlike conduct against Chilton County.
And us.
Offsetting penalties, yeah. I would think that Coach Battles and company have got some ideas about these 15-yard unsportsmanlike and personal foul-type penalties that we've gathered up in the last few weeks. And there might be some repercussions from that. We'll see. Either way, we stopped them on third down. And there's a high snap that's going to go over Castile's head. And he got the punt off, and I don't know how he did that, but that was a great punt. Hit the 35, going to be picked up by Chumley on the hop at the 28. He'll get to the 33.
How did he get that off?
I don't know. It was a great punt on top of it.
And our guy down here, he didn't realize it, but he could have actually hit him.
Yeah. Well, he's trying to get to him.
I guess.
It was an unbelievable job by the punter. All right, Tallassee ball, 5:51 left. Kent leading Goldmine 13-9. That's a big robbery game. Goldmine Road, Kent 4A Stoppers. Thank you, Ben Taylor. Tigers running right with Hooks out across the 40 to the 45, first down.
Good hard run by Hooks.
Yeah, he picked up about 12 yards. Theodore leads Opelika in the fourth quarter. It's 13-10.
Good ball game.
Yeah, Stanhope and Prattville now tied up third quarter, 14 all. McCary now in the Wildcat. First and 10 from Tallassee's own 45. Runs left. Gets to the 50. Picking up five. It'll be second down and five. Seeing some new players in on defense, too, for Chilton County.
Yeah. Big number 78's out there, or 79 for them. That's the 360 guy. Got to be.
It is. Well, one of them's 360. The other's 385.
That might be the 385.
I think it's 385, yeah.
Big boy.
He looks every ounce of it.
Power set. You got like Big Ben Carwile back in the backfield with got a couple of big linemen in front of Hooks. Right side run. He'll get to the edge and pick up only a couple. Riddick still in there for Chilton County. Came in to make the play.
Yeah, he's still out there, but if I'm his head coach, I get him off the field. You got 3 minutes left to go in the game. You're up 28-0.
We had Lattimore and Carlisle in the backfield on that set right there. A couple of big linemen playing up in front of the running back there, Hooks. Third down and three. 3:20 left in a football game. McCary, right goes wide to the right side. Same formation. It is Christian running right side behind his blocker who missed it that time. Fourth down, we're going to have about a yard to go. It's Kerry got upended. He needed to get to the 45. He's at the 46.
Yeah.
Under 3 minutes to play.
Oh, yeah, you going for it right here.
Tallassee trying to save face a little bit, get a score, avoid a shutout. You hate those goose eggs. It's not going to change the outcome, but you don't want to have a 28-0 score up there. And in order for that to happen, they need to get a first down right here.
The extremes and the different weeks, 50 points 1 week.
Unbelievable. Yeah, I know it. Hooks running left. Better get in there quick. And I don't think he got there quick enough. It depends on the spot. He might have gotten
it. He gave him the 45.
They gave it to him.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, he didn't get much.
No, he
didn't need a lot, but thank goodness he didn't because just enough to move it. He was trying to pick a spot. He really just needed to dive in there at some point. That was too close for comfort, especially on a fourth and a foot. .152 left in the football game. First down, Tigers, 45 of Chilton County. McCary now in there. Right side run.
Oh, my goodness. If he carry, cut back.
Yeah, missed the hole there, and he will be stopped at the 42 after a three-yard pickup, second down and seven. A minute 30 left to play. Yeah, you mentioned that they haven't really subbed much. They showed a few guys. We had a little success, and they brought their guys back. And I don't know if you're trying to preserve a shutout. I don't think that's something I would worry about if I were a head coach up 28-0 at this point. But they got all their guys out there starting the game. It looks like we got most of ours. So.
Yeah, they brought number 33 back out. He's not been in the last two series. The guy that we've had so much issue with.
This would be a chance to get some players some work if it were me, but I'm not the coach. Here is McCary running right up the middle of the defense. He has a good run inside the 35. It will be a first down at the 34. That will stop the clock at some point. And it's still rolling. Finally, at 44 seconds. Actually, Chilton County used a timeout. We'll take a break.
He aimed
Game Day Clips in Tallassee and Millbrook for haircuts and more. Don't forget, after your trim, to kick back with a shampoo, scalp treatment, hot steam towel, and massage. No appointment necessary. Game Day Clips, 1224 Gilmer Avenue, next to 1220 Cafe in Tallassee. And 102 Dietzville Highway, next to the Front Porch Grill in Millbrook. Game Day Clips, where it's always game day.
Football and tailgating, two great traditions in the South. Here's another one that makes them better. Shopping at Tallassee Superfoods. Stock up on great tailgating items that make football watching even better. And if you're the host of a big party on Saturday, do it right with great steaks or boneless chicken breast or a grilling favorite, smoked sausage. Throw on the fixins and you're ready for football. Get it all at cost plus 10% at either location, Tallassee Superfoods on Gilmer Avenue or on Notasoga Road in East Tallassee.
Score 94 and hit 106.
Throw down the field is incomplete from Morris to Battles after the timeout was taken. 30 seconds left in the ball game, and it'll be second down and 10 from the 33 of Chilton County. Tallassee trying to finish it off with a score, down 28 to nothing.
Yeah, right there, Trent needs to learn to let go of that ball just a split second earlier, give our guy a chance to run under it. Those are things he'll see on film, though, and be able to correct that.
Play action, pressure coming. Out of the backfield, threw it behind the intended receiver. Segrist, incomplete. Clock stops now at 21.2.
You know,
third down and 10.
Right now, third and 10. If they're dead set on passing, the oh crap play. I mean, that would be something that might get them. You know what I'm talking about. Alabama's running a few times.
What is it?
Roll out to the right, throw it back across the field to a tight end or a back out of the backfield.
Yeah, they have done that over the years here.
But you got to clear out that side.
Yeah, we'll see. Hooks is in there. May not do anything here unless it's a trick play of some sort. Now, okay, there they got Trent back at quarterback. Here he goes, rolling left into the defensive pressure, comes back to the right. He will run it himself, and he will get to the first down marker and get a first down. The clock has yet to stop. Finally does at 7.6. And giving us one or two more plays. It'll be first down from the 21.
Well, he's going to start that clock as soon as it's six.
Well, he went out of bounds.
Oh, okay, that's right.
Yeah. .28-20 Alabama Christian with 2:27 left, leading Montgomery Academy.
How much is left to go in the game?
2:27.
Come on, Montgomery Academy.
Did you pick MA?
I did.
7.6. Time called for a delay of game. Back us up five more. But I picked Tallassee, and you picked Chilton County, so it'll wash out. Official said you're going to have to run the clock. Well, last play was out of bounds. So.
Yeah, no, you don't have to run the clock.
Well, he's indicating he's run. I don't know what he's trying to say. Yeah.
And they ran the clock for 14 seconds after we went out of bounds.
Yeah, it seemed like it. Yeah, they're kind of wanting to get this thing over. Here's Morris. Pressure coming. He will throw it to the end zone for Ellis as the time has expired. He caught the ball. It should be a touchdown if he was in bounds. And the official has said.
Touchdown.
Touchdown. Great play by Brody. He was being held, it looked like, and he made a great catch. So the shutout is gone. There's really no reason to run a kicking team on a 28-6 game, is it, with the time expired?
No, not really.
Usually it ends it. But I think the officials are going to have a conversation about that, whether they'll let them kick here or not. And that's it. No kick. Game over. 28-6 final. Brody Ellis on a nice catch from Trent Morris on the final play, 26-yard touchdown pass will be a nice way to close it. Not a happy game, though, overall. Just a nice ending. 28-6, Chilton County wins. We'll come back, wrap it up with our community home health and hospice post-game show next on WTLS Score 94 and Hit 106.
Here's Mark Bell with some exciting news from Bell Contracting.
Yeah, we've opened up a new group in our business, installing swimming pools, and we've really enjoyed some success with it.
I know this is the season to start putting in the pools as we move out of pool season.
Kind of funny you bring that up, because pool season for us is this time of year. We're doing pools that will fit basically any budget. We've got them from 10 feet long all the way up to 60 feet long.
How do they get in touch with you?
Bell Contracting on Facebook, bellcontractingllc.com on the internet. We'd love to visit with you.
There's a new vet clinic in Central Alabama. 4D Veterinary Services is now open on Highway 14 just past Heron's Crossroads. 4D is a full-service clinic with the latest state-of-the-art equipment. From x-rays to surgeries, you can rely on 4D. Open weekdays from 7:30 to 5:30. Appointments preferred, walk-ins welcome. 4DVet.com on Facebook and Instagram. 4D Veterinary Services.
Hey, it's Brad Parker
and Jamie Bush at Parker Tire and Service Center.
It's tailgating time. Don't let car troubles ruin your road trips.
Let us help you with new Michelin, Uniroyal, BF Goodrich, and Toyo tires.
Whether you're headed to the big game or just across town, change your oil, lube, and filter.
And don't forget a checkup for your engine.
Parker Tire and Service Center.
1508 Gilmer Avenue in Tallassee.
Hospice services are considered the model for quality, compassionate care for people facing life-limiting illness. At Community Hospice Care, it is our desire that you and your loved ones receive excellent care at the end of life's journey. As your only locally owned and operated nonprofit hospice, we strive daily to make a difference in the quality of life that you have. We provide expert medical care, pain management, nursing assistant care, emotional and spiritual support expressly tailored to the patient's needs and wishes. When a patient is admitted to hospice, we also pay for the patient's medications and supplies related to their diagnosis. Support is provided to a patient's loved one as well. Community Hospice Care can provide care in a patient's home, nursing home, or assisted living. Our team includes expert medical doctors, nurses, social workers, chaplain services, and so much more. Because we are your local hospice agency, all of our staff is local. This means fast on-call response time for you and your loved one. Community Hospice Care of Tallassee. Compassionate care in difficult times.
A simple flight can create connections and memories like no other. That's why flying local matters. The convenience, less hassle, and more time with those that matter the most. Fly local. Fly MGM.
The postgame show is brought to you by Community Home Health and Hospice Care.
is your final score. Chilton County wins. Tallassee scores on the last play of the game, but it is in the books. There were some fireworks down on the field with the handshaking, and coaches had to intervene, separate the two teams. Coach Mike Battles down there with Mike, is Brad Davis. Go ahead, Brad.
All right, Coach. A lot of fireworks there at the end, but the game for us started out. We played a really good first half. Second half got away from us, but the kids continued to fight. That showed there on the last play of the game.
Yeah. I mean, we came out, tried to get something going. I thought we did a good job on defense early on. We had that, I think it was the first or second drive where they went right down and scored, but then we kind of settled down, and, the offense made some plays, and, but they're a very talented bunch. You know, they got big guys, got guys that just had, they pretty much had more speed, and it just was tough on us, even when we blocked, to hold the blocks and them not be there to make a tackle. And so, and our kids got tired at the end. We got so many of them playing both ways. And so, I hate it. They played hard. We were better football. We got better. I mean, I know this isn't, it doesn't seem like it is, but, we got better, and our kids have not quit. I mean, you saw that right there. We scored a touchdown last play. And, and they'll go right back to work Monday. I know they're disappointed. You never want to have end a game the way we just did right there. We had a lot go on out here tonight, and there was a lot of things that could have been prevented had some measures been taken by some other people. But, it didn't. We got through it, so we'll move on to the next game.
I understand exactly what you're talking about, Coach. Appreciate your time.
Thank you, Brad. Brad's got an early start tomorrow. He's headed to see his daughter and some softball. 4:00, he'll be headed to Mississippi. Well, you know about those things, don't you, Oz? Those early starts.
Oh, yeah.
Saturday mornings.
Oh, yeah.
I guess we all do to some degree. Tallassee falls tonight. Another one of those tough losses, a game that we had a shot at. I mean, halftime at 7-0 and turns into a pretty decisive victory for the visitors from Chilton County and Clanton, Alabama. As we look at some statistics,
For Tallassee, 12 first downs, 36 rushes for 105 yards, 9 of 18 passing for 96 yards, and 3 penalties. I may have missed a penalty or two because there were so many both
Seemed
ways.
Like there was more.
Chilton County. So here's the funny thing. 13 first downs, but they had more explosive plays, of course. 20 rushes, 230 yards, 8 of 13 passing for 72 yards. Rough, just tough. It's tough to contain them because they move the ball on the ground, and it's tough for us to stop
it. Shane Yankee letting us know that when Tallassee scored on that last play way back, you might remember, 1984, they beat Chilton County on the last play in Clanton. They made them go for the extra point after they'd scored. That was a rule that's been changed. Certainly no reason to do it. But, wow.
So what's –
About time for everybody to depart. We've had two coaches are getting together to talk about this. A couple of coaches down there on the field still meeting. Well, you know, you got these contracts that get renewed.
Drag it out. We ain't got anybody here.
And will this one be back on the schedule for the next 2 years? I don't know. Now, I will say this. We're seeing something right here with one of the players that might have been involved in this, and he came out to I don't know if he was apologizing, but he went out to reach a hand out to shake hands with the Tallassee coaches, and I think that's something that some of the Chilton County coaches demanded that he do. I can give them nod for doing that right there as the coaches shake hands and we'll go back to our respective locker rooms.
You know, I'm all for kids celebrating, having fun, but it can get on that line. It can get on that border of it can get bad. It can be rubbing it in somebody's face, and I think that's the way some people take it.
You know, and it's one of those things. Last week at Marbury, we were worried about a situation after the game because we had a lot of the same thing going
right.
on, and they decided to just leave. We have this thing at the end of the game, and it's about sportsmanship, where the two teams go out and shake hands. It's a good gesture. It's tough. I know when you've gone out there and you played your tail off and it didn't go your way. But it's about growing up and doing the right thing, being mature about yourself. And I know it's easy for us to sit up here. We're not sweating and bleeding on the field. But
you got to win with class. You
and
lose
I don't know
class.
What stimulated what instigated this whole thing to break out. We had a couple of penalties in the game between the two teams. Obviously, with some of that going on, we've had that each week, it seems like. But something happened in the exchange between that 50-yard line and handshakes that turned into more. Thank goodness they got it under control, and it didn't end up being too bad. But anyway, sad to see that regardless. By the way, I know they're going to have scores in a minute, but I just got an update on Realtown, 68-3.
Right. Hey.
My gosh.
They had fun with that, didn't
they? And they're whipping Cleburne County right now up there in Heflin. And I truly thought that might be a good football game, but Realtown's got something.
Wait, what'd you say? Who'd they play?
Cleburne County.
There we go. Thought I heard you say Cleburne.
He's taking out me.
Maybe I've listened to everybody else.
He's listening to me too much.
Yeah, seeing some folks from Tallassee that are on the Chilton County side tonight. I guess you can cheer for both a little bit. 28-6 final here. It's time for our Player of the Game choice. We do the C.J. Ledbetter Superman Award. It's the Player of the Game presented by Tallassee Automotive. And this week, Brody Ellis. You know, he was already the student athlete of the game, and he's going to win that award for the touchdown, and that's kept us from being shut out tonight, the catch on the very last play. Brody Ellis, your Tallassee Automotive player of the game.
Up until then, I was thinking, Mason Battles, he had some good punts.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, he did. Mason actually has punted very well this year.
Yes, he
All
has.
Right, well, we got the gang there waiting to get to some scores and some calls. If you want to do it, you can get with them. 283-8200 is the number in the studio. And you're welcome to check in there with the – Well, Travis and Preston and Jack and company. that'll be there tonight, handling that till about 10:35 to be exact. Then the Lindy's Football Report and AP Stedham's As We See It to take you till midnight.
I can't wait to stay up for that.
It's good. He always has good guests. Well, that's a wrap from here. We'll be back here next week. Looking forward to homecoming. We'll be on the air with you early. Remember to get here early next week, and not just the things that happen during the week, but at the game, we'll crown the queen prior to the kickoff for homecoming next Friday night with Elmore County coming to town.
Remember, nobody does homecoming like Tallassee.
That is true.
This is correct, sir.
For the crew here, the Tiger Nation guys, Philip Beckham, Courtney Thornton, Therese Scott, who are here tonight handling those duties for Philip Nelson, Brad Davis, Stephen Oz Osborne, our producer Leanne Butler. Michael Butler, thanking you for listening and watching. Once again, your final score, Chilton County 28, Tallassee 6.